Hello, you spectacular specimens of humankind. You happy-go-lucky scamps of individuals. How are we doing? How's it going? Hello, you beautiful individuals. That intro song was a brand new band that I spontaneously found literally seconds before I pressed go live. They are called Gnome. And that song was called Wenceslas. And they are three people that have little gnome hats on, and I'm blown. I'm literally gonna link it in the chat right now because I was shocked and loved it. Loved it. Three dudes with little gnome hats on dancing away, talking about whatever it was they were talking about. You know what I mean? It was great. It was wonderful. It was glorious. I enjoyed it, right? I enjoyed it. Anyway, you beautiful beings, how you doing? How's it going? Hello, Hurricane. Hello, Zooty Booty. How's it going, Althina Luna? Captain Bambi's Revenge. How you doing? How's it going? Eris Ptolemy, welcome on in. Purple Bat, your glorious bean. One True Cripple. Hello, hello, hello. Missatia, welcome back, you glorious bean. Phoenix of the Fence coming in for 10 streams in a row. Whips off your clothes. Oh, I see how it is. Coming in here. Bollocko naked, even if you don't have bollocks. Bollocko naked, metaphorical bollocko naked. Good lord, Althina Luna as well with the 5 streams in a row. Good lord. Much better than watch than you. Scandalous. Scandalous, Biohazard. You know full well that this is a level of unbelievable sexual ardor you wish you could attain. How's it going, Biohazard? How you doing? Afternoon all, how are you doing on this freezing day? It is very cold today. It is very, very cold today. I'm doing all right. I'm doing okay. However, I will warn everybody, I've got a very strict finish time today because I've got a meeting I need to go to. The Pride parade in my hometown is meeting tonight, and then like meeting all the sponsors and stuff like that. And the main people want to get us involved again this year, which is absolutely fucking amazing. But we naturally need to go butter up some sponsors so that they can actually pay for us to go and do our stuff. So I've got a very strict thing, you know what I mean? 3:15? No, I'm not here for 6 minutes, Biohazard. I'm not here for 6 minutes. However, you know. However, I am thinking, however, because we managed to get the, Where are we? Oh. Pro streamer. Because we managed to do this, I'm thinking I might stream an extra stream this week. I might do an extra one. So there's a company that have just sent, they sent me a game key, for a game that looks absolutely fucking infuriating and yet really fucking cool at the same time. And I know how much you people love to see me get absolutely fucking furious. So I thought I might play that. I might do like an extra stream on like Thursday night and play that so that you can all watch me get slowly but surely infuriated. And you know, I thought that might be quite fun. So yeah, I might do that. I'm probably going to do that. Let's not even lie about it. Do you know what I mean? It's the only way to hear. I've just had a ma- Excuse me? Excuse me? All of the roars. How you doing, Patience? Thank you very much for the 200 little bitch to roar at me. I was very confused for a second there. Very, very confused for a second there. I didn't know what the fuck was going on. Right, where the fuck was I? The titties must be free. All about it. Maybe you should wear a hat. Maybe I could wear like a little gnome hat. That'd be quite fun. I've been contacted by a whole load of different sponsors recently, so I might be doing a sponsored stream in the next couple of weeks, which would be really fucking cool and fun, and you know, the help with the bank accounts and bits and pieces. But if I do, then I'm gonna have to dress up for it. Do you know what I mean? I don't know what I'm gonna dress up as, but I'm gonna have to dress up for it. I'm gonna have to do something with it because it's me. I can't do a sponsored stream without dressing up. Depends what the sponsor, what they're prepared. It's all in the negotiation phases at the moment. But if they're happy to do it, then do it, you know? It'd be fun.
You subscribed. Most kind.
Genre! How you doing, little brother? Coming in here, gifting a cheeky little sub to Eris Ptolemy, you beautiful being you. You beautiful individual. Eris Ptolemy, I shall now inscribe your name upon the mirror of vain. Whoops, your finger slipped. By having your name pulled in the mirror of any means, you get access to my personal Snapchat. Not a bum Snapchat, you cheeky devil. And of course, you get access to all the sexy little emotes. But the most important thing is you got to roll over every morning, look in the mirror. Oh, God, I look rough. But God damn, do I make rough look good. Ooh, hurra, sexy. Ooh, yes, meow. You know? Oh, my lordy. How's it going, Kindred? How you doing, genre? Rafinza, fans, real W. Hello, patience, you glorious being. Athena, Luna. Oh, my lordy. All these beautiful people coming in here. Alessa Rave, how you doing? How's it going? You're singing with Pride with the Choir? Amazing. Wishful thinking, definitely biohazard. Dungeons Demona, hello, you beautiful being. Hope your meeting goes well. I'm sure it will. I'm going to slide on in there and become be unbelievably charismatic and flirtatious, and people will hopefully... these companies will happily go and throw money at the Pride organization so that they can pay us to do stuff, you know. You bully the ones you love, it's true. And Biohazard desperately tries to bully me. He fails miserably, but tries his best, you know what I mean? Tries his best. Lurking away, and you do your lurk work, JB. I appreciate you stopping by and saying hi, I really do. Let's try this again since Twitch decided to give me 6 minutes of ads. Oh my lordy. Well, that 6 minutes? That's surprising. It should only ever give you three, because I run 3 minutes of ads right at the beginning of the stream just to get it out of the way. Because the song that we normally do in the starting soon screen, whatever the song is at least 3 minutes long.
Help is on the way, dear! Help is on the way!
I'm glad help's on the way. I'm glad. I'm very glad that help's on the way. Because I need it. Patience with the other 200 little panderings to help me. I appreciate that. I like these new buttons. There's a whole load of them. Yeah. Whole load of them. It gets more and more scandalous as time goes on. You know? How you doing, Wonder Grubble Stupedia? Hello, you glorious bean. A game that's infuriating that isn't that Tomb Raider. To be fair, I never really found Tomb Raider infuriating. Do you know what I mean? ETA on the help. According to my very educational clock, on the way. Past. Past the way. You know? I've seen it ended the initial ads and it decided to keep me on my toes with extra ones. That's scandalous. That is absolutely fucking scandalous. That's not okay at all. But genre sorted it right out there. Appreciate you, genre. As much as I love abusing you, I need to step away from lunch. Go do your lunch. Go and snaffle some food. Biohazard. Go do the bits and pieces. Send all my love to all of the families. All of the family. You know? Thank you very much, everybody, for dedicating, throwing out your little channel points towards the dedicated Yorkshire stream. I don't even know how we're doing with that now. I can probably find out. How are we doing with that? Of the way towards the thing. By the way, if people are looking at the dedicated Yorkshire stream total and being like, why is it such a weird number? That is the population of East Yorkshire, which is where I live, all right? So I was like, if I'm going to do a dedicated Yorkshire stream, let's make the number the population of East Yorkshire. Let's make the number the population of my hometown, of my area. Do you know what I mean? So that's the reason why it's a really fucking weird and obscure number. Lurkaway MC, you beautiful bean. Thank you very much for popping in saying hi. Athena Luna, how's it going? Less than 4k to my confidence goal. Alas, not spending them on anything else yet. That is perfectly fine. The confidence points are for whatever you want them for. You want to save them up, you save them up. Genre, you lurk away, you beautiful bean. I have nothing to do at work today, so really happy to see you online. Spend some time here. Oh, I appreciate it. I appreciate people. Oh, God, I've got a shit chinos today. Don't know why, but I do. Let me just send this. That's good. So it's 7 to 10 business days, but at this rate is probably going to be 2036. Oh, Jesus, what a nightmare. Well, you did bail on Rise of the Tomb Raider. That's because nobody was interested in it. At the end of the day, Stupedia, as much as I genuinely am a happy-go-lucky scamp, I am more than happy to sit here and have a laugh. with everyone. Purple bat, we're bringing in a nightmare in here. I see you doing it. I see you. How you doing, somebody? And hello, you beautiful bean. Fucking the terrifying Amorous Sky. Hello, you glorious bean. Can I get a shout out for Amorous Sky, please? From one of my darling mods. Darling mod went away for lunch. It's fine. It's not a problem. I can do it. People, go check out Amorous Sky. They are a fantastic, glorious individual. We love them very dearly. Well worth all of your love and attention. Go click that jiggle of follow button on that wonderful bean. As much as I am all about the happy-go-lucky scampiness, Drupedia, the fact of the matter is, this is still my business. This is still my fucking career, do you know what I mean? So if people aren't watching a game, then I'm not going to keep playing it. It's a blast, do you know what I mean? I didn't stop playing Rise of the Tomb Raider because it was infuriating. I stopped playing Rise of the Tomb Raider because people didn't watch it. It was like, all right, cool.
You little stalker.
Thank you very much for the follow, you beautiful bean. I don't like to call people out just in case they're lurking, but you're very, very welcome on in here. Very welcome on in here, you beautiful bean. Less than 4k to your confidence goal, yeah. Babbly coming in here with their 10 streams in a row. Good lord, streaking all over the place. Put some clothes on. I know, like, it's meant to be spring and it's meant to be, like, warming up and shit like that. Do you know what, friends? That has reminded me. I am fucking furious, all right? Because at the moment in the UK, all we've been really having is storms. It's like, a little bit of sunshine, storm. Little bit of sunshine, storm. And it's been fucking exhausting. Not only is the weather fucking all over the place, the temperature all over the place, and therefore causing all kinds of fucking lurgies. Everyone's fucking ill. Everyone's fucking ill at the moment, which is a nightmare. Not only all of that, but I looked out my back garden. I've got a cherry blossom tree in my back garden, all right? It was just starting to open up, and when it hits, when that cherry blossom comes in, it is fucking exquisite. It is absolutely fucking beautiful. It is genuinely one of my favorite times of the year, seeing the cherry blossom in my, like, it's like a genuinely good sign that spring is coming back, and they were all just opening up, and it was beautiful and glorious, and now they're all on the floor. Now, all of them are on the floor. All fucking mush. Dirty brown mush on the fucking floor because the storm has just blown them all off. Blown all the fucking cherry blossom off. No, you're not allowed to fucking bloom this year. Fucked off. And people say that climate change isn't a thing. Bastards. How you doing, Valen? Long time no catch a stream. Just coming into the chat every now and then and mess things up with chat and stuff and how stuff stays. That is perfectly fine, patience. We appreciate seeing you. So thank you very much for popping by and saying hi. I do genuinely appreciate it. It's great. It's great to see people popping back in. I understand that, you know, you've got life. Life is going to work. Life is going to happen. You've got to go and do what you need to do because life. And I am never going to hold that against you. But, you know, it's just nice to see you. Welcome back on in. I'm doing all right. I'm doing okay. Had a bit of a depressive episode over the past couple of, past month. But we're pulling ourselves out of it because that's what we do, you know? I don't have depression, just in case people worry. I don't have depression. I just have a depressive episode every so often. Just pull that over so it's slightly less...
You're a loony.
I mean, this is true. I am indeed. I am indeed. Patrons with the 200 little bits again. I appreciate you. You're fucking Monty Python as well. God, that's fucking love Monty Python. Oh, I love Monty Python for the day and age that it came out in. Which is a very important line to make. Busy taking care of some stuff. We're lurking, but I'm soaking tea. You're still playing Dredge. Yeah. We should be hopefully finishing it today. Finishing the main game, and then there's the DLC. What I'm probably going to do is I'm going to start a new game online and then play the DLC offline, but, like, record it all and put it onto the VODs channel. I think I'm going to start doing that with a few more games as well. Patience. That predator noise constantly unnerves me, but thank you very much for the 200 little panderings as well. Just throwing all the little bitties at me today. All of the little bitties at me today, you cheeky devil. We do have, outside of the sound alerts and stuff with blurp, patience, we do have, like, a specific amount of things. Do you know what? I need to turn all those back on, don't I? Let me turn them all back on. Harrican, I'll be with you in 2 seconds. Do. No. Turn those on. Turn display the biddies on. Okay. Yeah, they're all back on now. That's good. That's good. They're all back on. But yeah, we have a whole load of different bitty amounts that you can select that has different effects and little things pop up and all that jazz. We're branching out and doing all the bits and pieces, you know? Doing all the bits and pieces. We needed that yesterday, but better late than never. Yeah, right? Didn't need to see that. Phoenix of the Fens is terrifying. Absolutely fucking terrifying. The nightmare is genuinely terrifying. That's the reason why it's called the nightmare, all right? I thought you bailed because of mechanics. The game mechanics were annoying, but it wasn't like stop playing it level of annoying. It was people, yeah, like I said, at the end of the day, like I said, this is my business. And as much as I love it and as much as I genuinely enjoy being around all of you and having a good time and stuff, I genuinely do, 110%. But I've got to gauge stuff based on like numbers. And if people, like if a game is just not getting people pander watching it, then I've got to go
pander
do something
to it. Pander you know what I mean? To it.
I enjoy using these two LOL rolling on the floor laughing. I just come in and F stuff up. LOL rolling on the floor laughing. At least you know I am here. LOL rolling on the floor laughing.
I certainly do, Patience. I certainly do. But you're throwing all your little bees at me. So, you know, I'm cool with it. I'm cool with it, you know? I'm cool with it. There's a whole lot of different, like I said, there's a whole lot of different ones. We're doing all the fun bits. All the fun and games. But I'm glad you're enjoying yourself, you cheeky devil. I'm glad you're enjoying yourself. Ooh. There is a delightful person just knocking on my door. I won't be a second. A fancy parcel came for me, but I'll open it afterwards. It's fine. It's not a problem. It's just random shit I've ordered, you know? Just bought new display cases. What are you displaying in the display cases, Abadi? What are you displaying in the display cases? How you doing, non-binary? Hello, Astra. You'll be streaking again. All of the streaking. For 15 streaks in a row, you've been streaking all over the place. Good Lord, what are you like? Drift off to sleep before I see you react to the news. I had 40-degree fever and hallucinations. Jesus H. Christ and the wee little donkey. You gotta be careful. Around 40 degrees is when the fucking body dies. Do you know what I mean? Like, that's... You gotta be careful. You gotta be careful with this shit, alright? The community challenge has been 25% cut. Fucking hell, 25% already? 25% already? We're gonna have to find some time to do a dedicated Yorkshire stream. Aight, calm yourself. Here we are, doing dedicated Yorkshire stuff. I'm gonna have to go find me flat cap. I've got a flat cap somewhere. I'm going to go find a flat cap and teach you all about dedicated Yorkshire things. Aye. Because that's the way we do things in Yorkshire. All right? Artemis Blackfire, hello, you beautiful bean. How's it going? How's it going? Display the titties. Display the titties. Already straight through it. Display the bitties, Althina Luna. Bitties, you cheeky devil. You sang then sounded like Predator. I can't do the Predator, fully Predator one, but I do a near enough Predator one, you know? Hurricane, are you still here, you beautiful bean? Patience, come here, cheeky devil. What do you like claiming cheeky kisses? I'll make sure Hurricane's still here before I give him the Victorian advice, you know? How you doing, Nivea and Hella, you beautiful bean? Bridget Jellies, yes, we've got all of the deep sea stuff going on there. You have no hurry. Blanche's advice has lasted over a century. A few more minutes won't hurt. It's all right. I got it. I'm on it. I'm on it now. Just don the spectacles. And stop the muzak. For today, friends, we're going to get some Victorian advice. Today, we're going to flip over from the don'ts for wives into don'ts for husbands. A book published in 1913, written by Blanche Ebert, published a year before the suffragette movement. So we were expecting a lot of scandalous advice. However, so far we've not been doing too badly. This is chapter 2, Personal Relations. Let's have a look here. Where were we? I don't understand that one, so I'm not going to say that. Not sure about that one. Let's have a look. Oh, there we go. There's a good one. Don't ever tell your wife a lie about anything. There should be entire confidence between you. If she once finds you out in a lie, she will not believe you when you do speak the truth. I agree with this. One must always be honest with your partner and or partners. Like, little white lies, and what I mean by little white lies, like, if you're doing, like, a surprise party for them, or some kind of joyous surprise, and you're trying to do it, and it's there for their benefit, and in a fun and interesting way, then that's fair enough, that's okay. But generally speaking, lying doesn't help anybody, all right?
Most kind.
Lying doesn't help anybody. Prags, thank you very much for giving that sub to Althina Luna, you cheeky devil. But yes, I completely agree, Blanche. Do not lie to your partner. Get the music back on. Prags, you cheeky devil! More Blanche wisdom. Yeah, honesty. Basic, simple honesty between partners, you know? Althina Luna, I should now inscribe your name upon the mirror. Vina. By having your name upon the mirror, Vaney, means you get access to my personal Snapchat. Not a bum Snapchat, you cheeky devil. And of course, you get access to all the sexy little emotes. But the most important thing is you got to roll over every morning. Look in the mirror. Good God, I look rough. But God damn, do I make rough look good. Ooh, harra, sexy. Ooh, yes, meow. Thank you very much, Prags, you cheeky devil. Oh, my lordy, all of the people dedicating their little channel points to the Yorkshire. Yorkshire stream. I know you're all excited for it, but calm yourself, all right? We'll be talking about Yorkshire tea and Yorkshire puddings and all kinds of things, all right? All right? Your hatchling has returned! Huzzah! How's it going, Creep Pete? Hello, you beautiful individual. How's it going? Let me give you a shout-out there as well. People, go check out Creep Pete. Creep Pete's a glorious, glorious human being. Been doing some Fallout 3. Is it your first time playing it, or are you replaying it? I started watching the new Fallout series, and it's good. I am enjoying it.
Most kind.
I am enjoying it, but it's not as mind-blowing as people were making it out to be. Maybe it'll get better. Maybe it's thinking, I'm now stopped watching it because I want to watch it with my little bro. Genre. Me and Genre are going to do, like, I'm going to go around to his, or he's going to come around here, and we're going to watch, like, episodes and stuff together. There's a little bonding thing between brothers. But yeah, it's good. I do enjoy it, but everyone was like, oh my God, this is amazing. And I'm like, it's good. It's watchable. It's fun. It's not mind-blowing. By any stretch of the imagination. I haven't heard you say hi yet in the chat. The person that's just subscribed with the Prime. Thank you very much for choosing to use your Prime here. I very, very much appreciate it. But if you're just lurking, I don't want to call you out. So I will inscribe your name on the mirror vein if you want to say hello. And I'll happily say hello back. Not a problem, but I just don't like... There we are. Oh, Amanda. Hello, you beautiful being. Hi, hi. How you doing? How's it going? Thank you very much for choosing to use your Amazon Prime subscription here. I appreciate it. Let me get the numbers right. 1417. Your name is now inscribed upon the mirror of Vayne, which means you get access to my personal Snapchat. Not a bum Snapchat, you cheeky devil. And of course, you get access to all the sexy little emotes. But the most important thing is you got to roll over every morning. Look in the mirror. And go, God, I look rough. But God damn, do I make rough look good. Ooh, harra, sexy. Ooh, yes, meow, you know? It's the only way to do it. She's with you, patience? Yeah? Oh, in which case, thank you very much for bringing your friend in here. I appreciate it. Ooh. I very much appreciate it. Ooh. Just making sure the fucking mirror doesn't fall over and break. Yorkshire Terriers? Potentially, yes. Potentially, yes. You know what I mean? What's stronger than T-Rex? A Yorkshire T-Rex? Very true. Very true. I'm drinking Yorkshire tea currently. Because Yorkshire tea is the best way. You know what I mean? Yorkshire tea is the best way. How's it going, Aldo? How you doing, you beautiful bean? You jinxed it, now you got a lot of work. No, let's say go do what you need to do. Thank you very much for popping over and saying hi. I really appreciate it. I'm displaying my Lego Burbs insects in display case. Zibadian, that looks... that. Honestly, if you are up for it, I would love to see a picture of that. Once it's all set up, once you've got all your Legos and stuff in the display case, I would love to see it. I would genuinely love to see it, because as much as I enjoy, like, all of the wild, big, fucking outrageous Lego sets and what have you, the little things... I've got, like, a little Lego lobster over there that a member of the community bought me. The little things are just... I find they're really cool and really interesting. So, yeah, if you've got... if you... are willing to do so, I would love to see it, you know? Document a case of the 50 C core temperatures in someone recovering from hypothermia. Really? I was always under the impression that if the human body got to 40 degrees C, like, internally, then your system just can't deal with it. Your system starts shutting down. Which is the reason why it's so problematic in, like, humid countries, because you can't sweat enough to cool yourself down, so you just gotta, like, keep jumping in waterfalls and getting showers and stuff like that just to cool down your core temperature, you know? Yeah, I know. Switched over to that with such ease. Now I'm wondering if you actually speak like that, and this is an accent. This is all just a performance, Eris told me. All just a performance, naturally. Naturally, aye. This is me natural voice. Sometimes I feel like I've got to speak, like, posh-like, you know, so that everyone understands what I'm talking about. But this here is a full natural Yorkshire lad. One must really indulge, you know, oneself in Yorkshire tea, Yorkshire puddings, and the occasional biscuit, you know? That is the voice that will 100% be done for the entirety of the Yorkshire stream. The entire Yorkshire stream will just be fucking that accent. Mine's that bitty, though. Fine if you've only the bitties are displayed. Mine can get back in the hoodie. Huh? I'm so confused. I think, what? Explain yourself. Does it contain fish? Man, are you there? I, yet always. Always there. Always. Wherever it is, wherever there is, that's me. I'm there. And yes, they contain fish. The light's off at the moment because daylight saving time rolled everything back, but I've just realized that that's not on. It's fine. Sorry, they'll wake up in a minute. You know? They'll wake up in a minute. A little Victorian wisdom. Exactly, right? From the Victorian period. Actually, technically speaking, the Edwardian period, but it's fine. Doesn't matter. No one's going to question it. It's historical. It's fine, right? Right? Do read into the mentality of someone who writes such a thing, and they may think they're being completely novel with the idea not to lie. To be honest with you, Aldo, I think, like, these books, like the don'ts for wives, don'ts for husbands, don'ts for mothers we've got as well. I genuinely think it's just nobody has ever written common sense down, so Blanche decided to write common sense down. I think that is literally it. I think it's just like, cool, these are things that everyone should know, and because nobody has actually ever written them down, I'm gonna write them down so that people can't make excuses as the fact that they didn't know. It's just like, no, it's all there in black and white. Don't lie to your husband. Don't lie to your wife. Just don't be a dick. You know what I mean? They are basically rules on how not to be a dick in a relationship. Which is fucking great, to be honest with you. How you doing, Finley? Hello, you beautiful queen. Calandra, hello. How's it going? Honestly, I would like to learn how to make a Yorkshire pudding. Yeah, we can definitely do that. It's the same shit as pancakes. It's the same shit as pancakes. Or, more specifically, it's the same shit as crepes. You put them in a flat frying pan for crepes. You put them in a little dish for Yorkshire puddings, effectively, you know. But we can go through it. It's not a problem for our wonderful Yorkshire day. I think Fallout 3 is today. Yesterday, he was playing Dark Souls 3, defeating bosses with doors. Oh, my lordy. Not the doors. Doing good. How about you? Only thank Gandhi for the shout-out. Still going I'm still going to start it. We finished Dark Souls 3 yesterday and changed the category already to save time before streaming. You know the drill. Oh, I don't know the drill. I set everything up 3 minutes before I press go live. before I've got the routine that I go through and sometimes forget parts of it is do my announcements like 20 minutes before stream, being like, I'm going to be live in 20 minutes so that people have the time to get the notification, get themselves settled in, and then get ready to watch the stream. Then set up whatever the screensaver is that we're going to be doing for our starting soon screen. Set up the music that we're going to be doing. Get my Firebot up and ready. And then change the stream title and category on Twitch. Then press go live. Then press activate the Firebot. Then go make a cup of tea. Oh, and press play on the music, you know. How you doing, Taken? How's it going? Little fly-by drive-by. Love it. Hope you're doing well and your head is feeling a little better attached this week after last week's wobble. And frankly, if not, that's okay. I hear the clouds are lovely this time of year. Not a bad place to store your head while you rebalance. To be fair, I'm feeling that. I'm doing all right. I'm doing okay. I'm much better and much happier now than I have been for a couple of weeks. So yeah, we're doing all right. Cracking on forward, you know what I mean? Cracking on forward. Pulling back that optimism, you know? I hope you're doing well, friend. I know that you are a ridiculously hard worker and you're constantly fucking working, but I just hope that life outside of the workplace, life is also treating you well as well. You know? I mentioned I follow your TikTok. Huzzah! Thank you very much for following the TikTok. I very, very much appreciate it. I need to do more TikToks. I've fallen a little bit by the wayside with the TikToks. I've been busy with doing other bits and pieces, but I really need to get back into it, you know? I watched the whole show and never played any of the Fallout, so I'm actually pretty excited. I really enjoyed the thematic of the whole Fallout world. The Fallout world is really, really cool. It's a very, very fascinating world for sure. And I do find it very, very interesting the way it's like an alternate future type world. Fallout, the first ever Fallout I played was Fallout 2. And then I played a little bit of Fallout 1. And Fallout 3, I absolutely fell in love with. Absolutely fell in love with it. And I'm gutted that I wasn't a streamer at the time, because I would have loved to have streamed that. Genuinely would have loved to have streamed it, you know? All we can do, bud, keeping busy and one foot in front of the other. 100%. 100% taken. Just constantly pushing forward, because you can't change the past, so why try? You know? Learn from it. Move forward. Andrew's long-time fan had to get her onto Twitch for all this chaos. Ah, oh, I appreciate that. Well, you are very, very welcome here, Amanda. You are very welcome here for the unreasonable levels of chaos and ridiculousness. In a little while, we will be jumping into a game. I don't really play games on, like, TikTok or any other platform. I've got my VODs on YouTube, but I like
how
to...
How about new?
Exactly. How about new? I don't really play... Like, I tried to make... a variety of different content across all the different platforms so that people that follow me on all the different platforms are still getting something a little bit different on each of them. And yeah, that's kind of the way that I tend to do it. So you'll see me playing games here on Tuesdays and Wednesdays. The VODs go over to the VODs and Vanity YouTube channel. There are plans in the works. To do some more interesting gaming style stuff in a couple of months' time, but that's still in progress at the moment. So that will appeal to maybe 20% of this audience, and if it doesn't, that is perfectly okay. You know? Still be here more lurking than chatting, that is entirely fair. How you doing, Finley? How's it going? Explaining myself, my titties are not bitties. And since you only want to see the bitties, man could get back in the hoodie. Oh, I get it. Ah, that makes sense. That makes complete sense. Athena Luna, 110%. But you were streaking through here, so I know full well your titties are not back in the hoodie. They're happily flailing themselves around the place like little disco tits. I am all too aware of what you people are like streaking all over the place. Good Lord. Science Alert published a theoretical curve between 35 degrees and 50 degrees humidity to 46 degrees.
Never had anything like it. It says it's mayonnaise, ketchup, and wash your sister's sauce.
Did you just say wash your sister's sauce? First off, you shouldn't be washing your sister's.
Hey, that is, you shouldn't be washing your sister. What happens if your sister needs help and you're there as a carer, all right? There's nothing particularly sexual. It doesn't have to be a fucking sexual thing, all right? Worcestershire sauce Not wash your sister sauce. Wash your sister sauce is something completely different and potentially is sexual and therefore should probably be avoided, all right? However, you are much likely to find it on Pornhub, especially if you are if you're in the UK, because the fucking first thing that is tells you in Pornhub, you go onto Pornhub in the UK and it's like, what's that? You want stepsister, stepbro, stepmum, stepdad, all of the step things? You want all of the family stuff? You want to put the win in wincest? Is that what you want? Yeah, let's do that. You always said the what's this here sauce? What's this here sauce?
Yeah, you subscribe.
We're Chestershire.
Most kind.
Ha ha ha, not all of the step things.
Honestly, country babe. It's like, fortunately, I actually have the Pornhub year in review because I've been wanting to do a video of it on the YouTube channel. Fortunately, that has changed. In the UK, the most searched terms have been MILF. People have been really into MILFs in 2023. However, in 2020, I think it was 2021 or 2022.
Pander to it.
PMSLLOL rolling on the floor laughing. That's far longer than I expected.
Well, what can I say? It happened. It still happened. All right. Yeah, the 2020, I think it was 2021 and 2022, the Pornhub review. So every year, Pornhub do a review of what is the most popular pornography across the entire world, or all the places that Pornhub is rolled out to, which is hilarious because it's now banned in Texas, if I remember correctly. Nowhere else. No other porn sites, just Pornhub. Interesting. But yeah, the number one in 2021, 2022 in the UK was family porn, like stepbrother, stepsister, stepdaughter, stepmother, all of that stuff. Yeah, that was a fucking eye-opener for the UK. Anyway, where was I? Country babe! Thank you very much for coming in here for the 3 months, you cheeky little devil. I have now inscribed your name upon the Mirror Vein, which means you get access to my personal Snapchat. Not a bum Snapchat, you cheeky devil. And of course, you get access to all the sexy little emotes. But the most important thing is you go roll over every morning, look in the mirror. Good God, I look rough.
Behold the power of cheese.
Yes, all of the power of cheese. It's a very powerful thing. In fact, it's so powerful that I know people who are lactose intolerant and still just eat cheese because the cheese is worth the suffering they go through, you know? But the most important thing is you got to roll over every morning, look in the mirror, and go, God, I look rough. But God damn, do I make rough look good. Sexy. Ooh, yes, meow. You know? You're afraid to know what America is? France. The Philippines. Let's have a look. See.
I may not have a brain, gentlemen, but I have an idea.
Exactly. And to be honest with you, I frequently don't have a brain. In the United States, the most number one search term for Pornhub in the year 2023 was lesbian, followed by MILF, followed by hentai. There you go. There you go. Patience, you've been spending all the little bitties today. All the cheeky little bitties. Thank you very much. I very, very much appreciate it. Duchess Demona. Well, hello there, you cheeky devil. Hello there, look at you coming over here, getting all up in my business, getting all close and personal, getting all up in my business. Good Lord, what do you like? What do you like, you insatiable individual, you scandalous. I really hope that doesn't DMCA me, but it's fine. Don't just moan at you cheeky devil. Thank you very much for the 200 little panderings. I appreciate you. And what fucking timing as well. What fucking timing, you scandalous individual. Getting all close and personal with my delightful features. That timing was beautiful. Absolutely fucking beautiful.
Oh! Oh!
God damn it. Jesus. That is either a Muppet motorbike getting more and more excited, or the way that I giggle when McSteffels walks in wearing lingerie. Fact. Fact. I don't know. What am I on out of 300? We are at... It'll be slightly different now, but 120 out of 300 now. So this, for those people that don't know, this is the plus points thing that Twitch are doing. So if you get 100 sub points, which is comes from people...
Yeah, you subscribed. Oh, most kind.
Purple bite, you beautiful bean. I'll be with you in 2 seconds. Thank you very much for giving that sub to Aldo. I really appreciate it. So this is not gifted subs and not prime subs. This is only paid subscriptions. Paid tier 1 is 1 point, tier 2 is 2 points, tier 3 is 6 points. And basically, I need to get 100 sub points in order, 100 sub points for 3 months consecutively in order to get a 60-40 split, which we have done according to what Twitch have done recently. So as of May, I should be on a 60-40 split, which is fucking mind-blowing and so cool and really awesome and fucking flabbergasting to me. And if we get to 300 points, which I'm not aiming for by any stretch of the imagination, we'll just let that happen when it happens. Do you know what I mean? If we get to 300 points, then for 3 months in a row consecutively, then it means we get onto a 70-30 split. And the 60-40 and 70-30 splits last for 12 months. The longer that you go on getting the 100 points, the longer the 12 months keeps rolling on for. Do you know what I mean? Thank you very much, Amaris. I really, really appreciate it. It's been a beautiful,
yeah,
hard slog.
Subscribed. Most kind.
And I really appreciate all of the dedication that people have put in there. It's been weird because yesterday I was like, oh, I'm going to push for it because we're so close already. I want to get it done. But I'm also like feeling really weird and awkward at the fact that I'm actually saying, hey, people, if you want to subscribe, that's cool. How's it going, Dabacox? How you doing? Patience. Thank you very much for giving that sub to a lesser rave and purple bat. Thank you very much for giving that sub to Alder on the Rocks. I shall now inscribe their name upon the mirror of Vain.
Yeah, you subscribed. Most kind.
And patience coming in with the prime as well, you beautiful bean. Thank you so much. But all of your names have been inscribed upon the merit of Vain, which means you get access to my personal Snapchat. Not a bum Snapchat, you cheeky devil. And of course, you get access to all the sexy little emotes. But the most important thing is you got to roll over every morning, look in the mirror. Good God, I look rough. But God damn, do I make rough look good. Ooh, herra, sexy. Ooh, yes, meow, you know? You know? You cheeky devils, you. Yeah, yesterday we did, it's getting to the end of the month, and if I basically didn't get it, because we got it in February, we got it in March, and if we didn't get it in April, I would have absolutely kicked myself. So I was like, right, I'm going to swallow my own pride, I'm going to push and let people know that I'm actually pushing for it, and yeah, we're gonna do that. And we did, we managed to do it, so now I don't have to talk about it again, because I'm like, yay, we did it, cool, move on, don't have to keep going, just move on, we're good, we're all right, we're getting done, you know. And all that jazz. So yeah, so a massive, massive thank you to all those people that have subscribed. It genuinely means the fucking world to me that you would choose to spend your money here, you know? And to all the people that have subbed and thrown their primes out as well, the fact that you would choose to gift subs to this community and choose to use your prime here over all of the 10,000 odd other channels that exist, I really, like, it genuinely is very, very humbling. Very, very humbling, you know? Right, where was I? Very far behind, as per usual. Common sense rules, perhaps juxtaposingly not common. Oh, Aldo, common sense is definitely not common by any stretch of the imagination. And it's that classic thing, oh, well, it's just common sense. And it's like, well, nobody's actually written it down. Apart from Blanche, apparently, you know. Science alert proposing the imminent death curve. Correction, science alert published a theoretical curve between 35 degrees and 100 degrees humidity and 46 degrees and 5% humidity. All of this is great, but I don't understand it. I don't understand it. I'm very confused. Oh, 50% humidity. Okay. Is that like the specific climates and temperatures of most likely for the body to overheat and organ failure? You know? What's the target out of 300? There's no target. Like, we've done the 100 and that's me good. Do you know what I mean? Like, that's my thing. I'm like, we've done the 100, I'm good. Do you know what I mean? I don't, like, in order, the only time that I would push for the 300 is if we'd already done 2 months of the... If we'd done 2 months of 300 already, and then on the third month I was really close to it, I'd be like, cool, let's push for the 300. But because that hasn't happened, like, I'm not going to push for it. I'm not... I feel really awkward. I feel really awkward being like, hey, friends, give me your money. Give me your money, friends. Why don't you subscribe to me? Why don't you do the thing? Give me your money. That would be great. That would be wonderful if you just gave me your money. Like, I feel super fucking awkward doing that. Genuinely super fucking awkward doing that. So, yeah, I don't... I just straight up don't. Do you know what I mean? What do you get the 300 instead of the 100? So, When you signed up to the monetization agreement with Twitch, you basically, every sub is a 50-50 split. So every subscription is a 50-50 split. So 50% go to Twitch and 50% go to the streamer, okay? And that's whether it be affiliate or partner, it doesn't really change. It's the same. You know, it's 50-50 down the rain. 50% to Twitch, 50% to the streamer. If you get 100 points 3 months in a row, it goes to 60-40. So 60% to the streamer, 40% to Twitch. If you get 300 for 3 months in a row, 70% to the streamer, 30% to Twitch. So basically, it's an extra 10% of your earnings every month. Okay? Does that make sense? Is that all good? As L'Oreal historically would tell us, you're worth it. Oh, you! Thank you. I very much appreciate it. I'm glad that you feel that I am worth it. I'm glad that you feel that I'm worth it. I don't disagree. I feel like I'm worth a million, billion, trillion pounds. But I do not take that for granted. Do you know what I mean? You know? My ADHD requires me to plan stuff for streams. The amount of times that I've forgotten to turn on the camera. That is fair. That is fair. Do you know what I mean? That is entirely fair, Creepyz. How many episodes did you watch so I can catch up with and watch the rest? Genre, I watched the first two episodes of Fallout, the Fallout season. If you want to watch the first two, we can crack on from there. We can crack on from there. I Am Genre is my little brother, by the way, friends. Go check him out. This is my little bro. This is my little brother. He's just come back to streaming after a prolonged period away from the wonderful world of Twitch. And yeah, you should go check him out. Go click that cheeky little button. Go do the bits and pieces, you know. 30.6 degrees. Was it proposed at a point where the capacity to fight temperature begins to struggle? Okay. Above that, 100% humidity can cause death as time progresses with the temperature reaching 35 degrees. Wow. Okay, that is pretty scandalous. That is pretty scandalous. Good lord. 20% of me? Should appeal to my lower legs. Yeah, could you imagine? If it was like... Okay, I'm pretty sure that my external limbs in cold weather would very much appreciate being a higher temperature, you know? Streaking through on 20 streams in a row, Dapper Cogsworth. Good lord. What are you doing, nakedified all over in here? Good lord. What are you like, eh? How's it going, Dapper Cogsworth? I almost called you DC for a second there. I was like, how's it going, DC? How you doing? I made Dapper Cogsworth street. How's it going, DC? How you doing? Feeling good? Feeling great? Feeling wonderful? You a comic? You know? Itchy nose. I'm afraid to know what... Yeah, so there you go. I'm lactose independent. That is entirely fair. Cheese be like that, though. Do you know what I mean? In the future, approved pronouns may include cheese. That is fair. You are what you eat. And if you eat nothing but cheese, then, you know. My new motto, definitely positive vibes. I need love to see it. I believe they only break the US down by state, except Texas. So they do a generic overall view in Pornhub, but they definitely do then break it down by state after that, which is really, really interesting. I haven't done the review yet, but I will do. I will do. All of the tentacles. Yes. The ones by state were fascinating. A couple of years ago, I looked into the Pornhub report, and I found it very, very interesting that across the Bible Belt, across the areas that are so unbelievably bigoted in their views, very anti-LGBTQIA, and usually quite racist in many of their ways, tended to love African-American homosexual porn was the prime one in like the year 2019 2020. It was like that was the thing, and I was like, of course it is. Of course, the number one pornography is the stuff that is looked down upon across these parts of these regions of the world. Now, do you know what? I think that is generally a particular recurring theme across the entire world. The areas where things are taboo is the most likely you're going to see them, you know? When something's taboo, it's like, fucking let's go, you know? On Snapchat, it's tier 4. It is tier 4. That is the only way to do it. Friends, in about 5 minutes, there will be some advertisements. I'm going to use that opportunity. I was normally going to dance and do all the bits and pieces, but I'm going to use that opportunity to go visit the urination station because I've had far too much fucking tea today. But we're cracking on. We're cracking on. It's all good. Don't worry. You won't be missing anything is basically what I'm going to say. You know what I mean? So this is not Sparta. It's not Sparta's about it. It's not 300. This is very much only 100. We're a third of Sparta. With a sp... Why, Valen? Why did you have to say this? Why? Why did you... Why did that... Oh, my God. How's it going, Jason Andrew? How you doing, you beautiful man? Vicious Grim. Hello, you cheeky devil. Have you tried the horror game Slay the Princess? Psychological horror. I think you may enjoy the story perspective. And hi. How you doing? How's it going? I haven't, no. I have seen it, though. I have seen it. At the moment, I don't know what we're doing with games, to be honest here. I'm not sure what we're doing with games. I'm trying to never... I am aware that this community... one of the great things about this community is we literally come from all walks of life. And all ages, all cultures, all sexualities, all genders. That's what I fucking love about it. But as a result, I am also aware that there are a large portion of this community who don't like horror games, okay? And that's perfectly okay. That's all right. So I try to only ever play one horror game at a time. At the moment, we are playing Poppy Playtime Chapter 3. I've found some bugs in it, which I need to tell the devs about, but I was just going to list an entire collection of them by the time I finish it and send it out to them. Yeah, I'm playing Poppy Playtime 3. After that's finished, then maybe we'll be looking at another horror game, because I fucking love I love indie horror games. Like, I can't say that I'm a massive fan of, like, the big AAA horror games, because I just, like, they've never really grabbed me, apart from, like, Alien Isolation and shit like that. But I do love my little indie horror games. Indie horror games are fucking great. Absolutely fucking great. It's like a personal passion of mine, do you know what I mean? So it's your turn to do it. Oh, yeah. But I'll always take suggestions. I'll always take suggestions where I actually have, like, an entire form. There you go. If you would like to suggest a game, not just you, Vicious Grim, but anybody, if you would like to suggest a game, go on to the weird tiny URL. It opens up a form. You can submit it for consideration. Sometimes I used to do every single game was voted for by the community, but I actually realized that massively restricts me in so many different ways. So I'm trying not to do that now. I will continue to do game votes, but I'm changing the way I do it so that I'm less restricted. It basically means that I'm more flexible to do like sponsorships and stuff like that, depending on what's going on, you know. Binge watched the Fallout, then got a ton of things explained to me as how I assume you come to the show knowing. Yeah, so I think Fallout is one of those TV series where it's good to know the game first. There's a lot of things in the first couple of episodes. Like I said, I've seen the first couple of episodes where I watched them and was like, oh, this is really interesting because this in the game, it's very, very true to the game. The TV series is very true to the game, which I fucking love. But I watched the first couple of episodes with McSteffels, and McSteffels doesn't know the world and doesn't know the lore and was like, all right, it's an all right watch. But like, there was lots of things that I was getting excited about that McSteffels was fucking clueless about. Absolutely fucking clueless, because she had no idea about the world. No idea at all. So I found it, I thought the first couple of episodes were all right. I thought they were okay. Loads of people have been screaming and raving about it. Oh my God, it's the greatest thing ever. And it's just like, it's all right. It's easily watchable. I do want to watch the entire series, but I wouldn't say that I'm fucking mind blown by it. Do you know? You know? Weebs rule the hub? Yeah. there's a very interesting collection of statistics on the end of year report for sure. Do you know what I mean? Being a Spur sounds beautiful, to be honest. Exactly, a Spur. Marvin Gaye approves of your small debt. Apparently so, right? So I enjoy channel video. Like, I try my best. You know what I mean? I try my best. What was that game you played a while ago with a dice that looked like Tim Burton? Fucking hell. That is actually on my Thurston Vanity channel. Lost in Random. I don't even need to look it up. Yeah, Lost in Random. Thank you very much, Jason Andrew. Lost in Random. Great game. Really, really enjoyed it. Was really good that I didn't highlight the entire series. So they disappeared. So like, I've got like the first half the game on my YouTube, and then the others just disappeared. I thought I'd highlighted them all, but apparently I hadn't, and the others just disappeared, which means there's only half a fucking game on there. I'm really pissed off about it, you know? Gotta leave the stream completely as I have to pay attention to work information. No, go do your thing, JB. Go do your thing. Friends, I'm gonna get up. I'm gonna go visit the urination station. When we get back, we'll jump into Dredge. We'll go do the bits and pieces and what have you. So get up, have a stretch, stretch your eyes, look at some in the distance, and the back again. Grab some kind of beverage, hot, cold, or if the time is permitting, flamboyant as fuck. Don't forget to take your meds. If you haven't done already, take them now, you cheeky devils, if it is the correct time to do so. And if you're wearing a binder, have a couple of deep breaths, stretch those lungs out, stretch those rib cages out, and never wear a binder longer than is medically recommended, which is what we consider to be 6 hours. I'll be back in approximately 2.5 minutes, and then we'll jump into the game, all right? Very, very much appreciate you waiting, you delightful individuals. I just needed to pee, but then I quickly opened up what was in the package to see if there was anything interesting. Not particularly. Stuff like fucking earbud cleaners and shit like that. Not the ones that you stick in your ear, but you know, like the things that you use to clean earbuds. Like wirelessy things. Anyway, cephalopods blowing kisses, the best way. The best way, if anyone was going to blow a decent kiss, I'm sure it'd be a cephalopod, because it would grab onto your face and anyway, beak you real good. You're going to get the pun out for that, have them now, the cuttlefish. Cuttlefish are a thing on Subnautica, you know what I mean? A lesser rave, I'm afraid we only speak English here. I've got no idea what you're saying there, my friend. No idea what you're saying. A face hugger? Exactly. Currently playing Subnautica? Great fucking game. Great game. I actually preferred Subnautica to Subnautica Below Zero. However, Subnautica Below Zero has more lore in it, which is interesting. I hope they make more of them. I really do. You know what I mean? I know there will be a reason for this, but why is that your Be Right Back video? So SJ, basically, I put on a different screensaver for the starting soon screen and the Be Right Back screen. It's usually the same video, whatever it happens to be. And I try to make it thematic to whatever we're doing. So if we're doing, if I'm doing a just chatting, I just tend to do something that's quite fun, like various different colors meshing into each other and doing bits and pieces. With us playing Dredge today, we've got lots of sea creatures going on, because I fucking love sea creatures and I'm really enjoying Dredge. How you doing, Sazzle? How's it going? The What's? Yeah, if we're doing something like, fucking when we played Hollow Knight, it was all monochrome, that kind of thing. I'm trying to, just because I get bored and I like to spice things up, basically. That's what it comes down to. I get bored, I like to spice things up. I got the idea originally from Classy Katie. Classy Katie had this thing where it was like all these different colors meshing together, like inks and stuff all blurring around. And I was like, fucking hell, that is cool as shit. I'm going to steal it. You know? Oh, and CK was like, yeah, do it. Do it. Very cool. Did you officially hit the partner plus goal? We did, Memnot. Yes, we did. We did indeed. Where is it? Hold on. There we go. 120. We only needed 100 plus points. And we are here. We have hit 120. So theoretically speaking, next month I should be on a 60-40 split, which is fucking amazing. So again, massive thank you to all the people that helped me out doing that. It means the absolute world to me. We're not aiming for the 300 because, as I mentioned a little bit earlier on, but for the new people that have just joined us, it makes me feel very, very awkward to ask people for money and ask people to subscribe and stuff. I need to get better at it, but realistically speaking, I've been doing this for nearly 6 years, so chances are I'm probably not going to get better at it. I will push for the 300 when we've already had 3 months of doing 300. Do you know what I mean? If we literally do two months of being at 300 plus points, and then we're in the last month of being at 300 plus points, then I will push for it. Because I'm like, oh, this is cool, let's push for it. But it'll still make me feel super fucking awkward. So yeah, you know, how you doing, Millen? How's it going? Valentine's Subnautica is so good. Looking forward to the sequel. They're making... Is it a Subnautica 2? Or is it something else? Stupedia. God damn it. Just because I've activated all of those again does not mean... God damn it. Subnautica 2? Cool. That genuinely does excite me. I really enjoyed Subnautica. Really, really enjoyed Subnautica. But thank you very much for asking, Memnot. With the fishy tentacle headdress was interesting. Do you know which one that was? No, I missed it. I was up having a wee. so I missed half the things that were in the Be Right Back screen. What did it look like? But did it have like a little... Was it like a lure? A little tentacly lure? Or was it like a part of it? Was it like a lionfish with like just weird little tendrils? Or what was it? Tell me more, you know what I mean? Oh, hell, I spawned too far and encountered a Reaper. I do that all the time. I got bored and wanted to do more excitement, so I just took out into the world. Into the wilds, you know? Look away now, Azumi. How you doing, you beautiful bean? Encountered a Reaper after 30 minutes is not a fun experience? No. It does, like, put you right at the edge of one edge of it as well, which I find always very, very interesting, you know? But anyway, friends, we're going to jump into the game. Today we are playing Dredge. We should be finishing it today, I'm hoping. But I do have a very strict cut-off point today, because I've got a meeting this afternoon where I need to go schmooze and get all my charisma out to help Pride get more money so that they can pay me to do all the adult area of Pride, which will be very nice indeed. That's not the game I want. Ooh, definitely not. This is the game I want. Look like a goldfish with a tentacly head? Oh, I don't know. A goldfish with a tentacly head. It could well have been, I don't know, something like a lionfish. Lionfish have got quite tentacly heads and they can be quite goldeny. Something like that? Perhaps? Mayhaps? Yeah, friends, we are jumping into Dredge now. This is potentially the last stream we'll be doing Dredge. I've decided that if I'm going to do the DLC and stuff, what I will do is I will record myself doing that offline. And if you would like to check it out, then you can check it out on the VODs channel, okay? No worries, patience. You take it easy. Thank you very much for stopping by. Thank you so much for all the little bits you threw at me and the gift sub. I really appreciate it. Yeah, thank you very much. I appreciate it. Go do what you need to do. Thank you very much for stopping by. Mwah. Much appreciation. We'll see you next time. We'll see you next time. But yeah, friends, this is my first time playing the game. As per usual, I don't like any kind of hints, any tips, any nothings. The less I know about the game, the happier I am as a human being. And yeah, let's jump into it. Let's get on to this last little bit. So, where the fuck were we? My pursuits. So I need to find the door. So I know where the door is. Catch a frilled shark. So I want to do that first. Before we do the thingy, we want to catch the frilled shark. And then I'm pretty sure that it was a volcanic one. Yeah, frilled shark. So we'll catch the frilled shark and we will... While we're here, I suppose, what we can do is we can give... We've got the thingy. Okay. All right. What we'll do is we'll pop over here with our super fast boat. We'll heal up, repair up even. And... repair. Cool. We'll also... Where's my crab pots? Oh, they're on the other side. Fuck. Okay, right, yeah. And we'll go and give this dude his pocket watch and we'll get this done. We'll get this done and done. You will lag away, SJ, you beautiful bean. Appreciate you. Appreciate you. Will you continue with Baldur's Gate 3? Are you done with it? Good question. That's another one where I'm like... Do I keep going? Do I play it offline and just record it? Because as much as I did enjoy playing it, it's a very... I felt like realistically speaking, I was, what, 11% of the way through the game and I played it for 13 weeks. And I was like, this game is so fucking big and people are just going to get bored of it because I'm not playing it every single day. Like, I feel like if I was playing it every single day, then people might be like, oh, yeah, we'll tune in and watch the journey or what have you. But it's just, yeah, it's one of those things. I don't actually need that. So, yeah, I don't know. How's it going, Zemba? How you doing? I need this first. And then go to the ruined mansion. You climb the broken steps to the old mansion, the waves swelling and crashing against the basalt columns that surround you. You pause before crossing the threshold to deliver the relic. He approaches, drawing closer with incessant ticking. You have the pocket watch. You take out the watch. Its once frozen hands are now inexplicably twitching in rhythmic struggle, trying but failing to move forwards. You place it in front of the collector. I thought it had been some decades since I last laid eyes upon this. The sounds of its mechanisms has grown no less unpleasant. And with that, our collection is complete. I must admit, I am surprised. I did not think you had the determination for such a job. Now, with these five relics in our possession, only one thing remains. I suspect you know it by now. Know what? It will become apparent soon enough. We must make one final voyage. This time, I will be with you. I need some time to repair. So be it. Return when you are prepared. What I want. Tell me all about the book of yours. This one here? With a wry grin, he pulls a dusty tome from the nearest shelf and glances at the cover. There's really not much to be said of the histories of the Grey Isles. It's quite the chore. Don't play dumb. You know which book I mean. Play dumb. Your hypocrisy is wearying. I suppose we must go through this rigmarole yet again. The Book of the Deep appears in his hands, sheathed in dirt and crimson jacket. Go ahead. Ask us. Where did you get it? We've done all of this. I'm just going to get it off him. Give me the book. He was hanging the space between you. You won't change a thing. The book is ours. Step closer. You take a step closer through the cracking room. The collector lurches forward in response. What can you possibly hope to achieve? Take the book. You strike out with your right fist, punching hard into the jaw of the collector. His face shatters and falls to the ground. pathetic. The Book of the Deep is in your hands. Understand this plainly. Before you sink us into despair, I know how to bring her back. It's all there on the pages. And now you've seen its power firsthand. We wield the power to release her from her slumber. We can undo everything. Undo what you did. Oh my fucking god. The Collector was our reflection? The Collector was our reflection. Guessing donor lights are off? They shouldn't be. Oh, Stupedia. Money, money, money. Must be funny in the Twitch man's world. Here, take my sofa. Thank you very much. I appreciate it. Take your sofa. Take your sofa change. Stupedia, thank you very much. People, if you've got some egos in chat, please say a massive thank you to Stupedia. I don't know why it didn't throw the alert there, but I appreciate you. Thank you very much. It should. All the alerts are on, so I don't know why that didn't work. Don't know. Thank you very much, though, Stupedia. You're beautiful beings. Very, very kind of you to throw your monies at me like that. I appreciate it. This is a game written to take over your life, but I enjoy those. Oh, God, yeah. Oh, Baldur's Gate 3? Yeah. Prepare just makes me think of 5v10p. Dirty mind, terrible things are waste. Yeah, right? Oh, honestly, this... So, I am fucking flabbergasted by what has just happened in-game here, right, friends? We have been collecting these relics... We've been collecting the relics for the Collector... And I didn't mean to rest, but never mind. And the Collector is our reflection. This entire time has been in our head. I did not fucking see that coming at all. I'd worked out that I was the fisherman from all of the tales, all of the little stories of the thingies that we've been finding. But... Yeah, I'd not worked out at all. Lighthouse Keeper. I'd not worked out that the Collector was actually just us. What is it? You've had it this whole time, have you not? It doesn't matter. Make the most of this window of lucidity. Now is the time to act. Do you still remember where it happened? In that gloomy darkness behind the bay. When you are ready, I'll point the way. Oh my god, okay. Oh my god. That's basically the crux of it. We are in a position now where we're at endgame territory and we get to choose either we go with the reflection of the Collector and we summon and bring back from the dead our wife who died, or we go with our Lighthouse Keeper and resign ourselves to whatever it is we're resigning ourselves to. Is this a frilled shark? No. I need a frilled shark to finish off those little bits. Once we finish off those little bits, we can... Once that's all finished off, I can do what needs to be done. Because if I'm going to do it, I'm going to do it properly. There's Mama. OK. Come on, where's the frill chuck? There, raise. Oop, cheeky. There, raise. Let's, can we get rid of you before we... Okay, we have got rid of you. Right. Where's that fucking shark? There we go. Hello. No, that's a ghost shark. That's not a frill shark. Shit. Where's the fucking frill shark then? Unless the frill shark only comes out at night. Good news, you have a big mansion. All right, that is good news. I do indeed have a big mansion. Hello. I don't really need to blow that up at this point. There's a storm coming. We'll head back over here. Oh. Take all. We can just sell all of those because we don't need any of them. Sell all. We're good. Alexander Devonport, long time no see, friend. How are you doing? How's it going? How is life treating you, friendo? This is not one. Take all, pick up. Oh, for God's sake. Pick that up. Can you kindly not be up in my business? Here. Something slivered into the cargo hold. That's fine. I don't need to worry about it. Damn it. Get rid of that. We don't need that. And then we need to go over this way. Get away from me. Life's a bit eh right now, but I won't get into anything right this moment. Well, I appreciate that you're not getting into anything right this moment, but I hope that whatever it is passes quickly, friend.
Raise the deep. The figure
points to a shape on the last scroll is one with a frilled shark. Take this frilled shark. They drag the shark's body around to find the right angle before plunging the knife in and pulling out the heart. They place it on a stand beside the others. Without looking at you, they take a book from inside their robe and throw it into the sand at your feet. The figure kneels before the fish's heart becomes still. You leave before they decide they need any more hearts. Okay, we are good in the proverbial hood. We're good to go. Skullmagger, how you doing? How's it going? Long time no see. It has been a while. How are you doing? How's things? Let's go here. Let's gather this. Spiky. Sickly stench rises from your cargo hold. Oh, cool. So if you don't get rid of stuff quickly, then it spreads. That's pretty awesome. I love that we've got to this point in the game before actually realizing that. That's hilarious. Doing well, been very busy. I'm glad to hear it. Glad you're doing okay. Everything okay? You've been standing there for a while. Do you just need a rest? Sell all of the fish. And then we can exit this. We can go to the shipyard and repair our little nets and stuff. What I really need to do is I need to do some abyssal. Fucking hell. All right. I need sleep is what I need. I want some abyssal crabs before I do anything else. Fish market. We can get rid of these. And then we can once again go in, repair all of the shark nets and stuff. Go over here, pick it up, and we'll nip right out into somewhere that's a bit more abyssally. Somewhere like here. 52, 55. You bastard. Because I'm going a little mad. I'm going slightly mad. How far down can we get? Okay. Let's take that. Hope you're doing about as well as what this nightmare game is about. I fear the ocean. You have a fear of the ocean? It is fucking great. I genuinely am really enjoying this game. And we're right near the end of it as well. Pushing the limits. So we need to do that. I really want to find the door, which I think is the one of the last things we've got to do. So we've done those. We'll go back over here to the ancient lighthouse and activate that. And then I'll come back and see what that's all about. You know, but I'm doing well. Thank you very much to Skull Maggot. Doing as good as I can possibly be, you know. Making the most out of things. Scare the little fuckers away. Oh, that's interesting. It's different times of the day that those stones activate. What I need to do is I need to map those stones out. Place a marker. That one. Different times of day. Right. Up to the ancient lighthouse. Put it in. The fused tablet clicks into place and the door rumbles before sliding aside. Step inside. You step through the doorway of the ancient lighthouse. The stairway to the top has collapsed. This is as far as you're going to get. Around you are a number of dusty objects. Some of them look valuable. Flame of the sky. 3,500 lumens. That's only 3,300. Oh, we're going to have to put you in the... Okay. That's not what I was expecting, but I'll take it. You take everything from the room. Was that everything? What's in the cave? Okay. What we'll do then is we'll head back to... We'll grab these. Do a little fishing while we're at it. Go back, sell a load of stuff. check out our crab pots, because I would love to be able to paint my wonderful ship a gothic black, and then we will look at doing the last bit. The last bit. How you doing, Alpaca Lunchu? How you doing? How's it going? Hello. Get out my way, get out my way, get out my way, get out my way. I'm going slightly mad. Ever so slightly mad. Be back soon after this meeting. Time to prefer, this time I prefer to close the stream so my phone won't be able to. No, that is perfectly fine, Alessa. You take it easy, beautiful bean. Thank you very much for stopping by. I appreciate you. Right, we'll sell all the fish. We'll also pop to the shipyard. We'll sell the massive light, as there is no need to then have it. This can give us another 750 lumens. That will actually give us as much time as we can possibly muster. We'll repair everything as well. There seems to be like the map there as well, which we haven't looked at. Let's fucking take that while we're here. Take that while we're here. We don't need any of that stuff. I think that's all fine and dandy, to be honest with you. Like, we're pretty clued up as much as we possibly can be. 15, 18, 19. Yeah, this is about as good as we are going to get with this stuff, to be honest with you. But we'll pop in for our research. We don't really need that, so we'll not worry about it. What are our pots at? All of our pots are done. Volcanic and coastal. Mangrove and shallow. Coastal and shallow. There's just so many different ones. We don't really need any of this stuff. This is the thing. This is what it really comes down to. We don't need any of that shit. And we don't really need to be any faster either. I suppose I'll spend my research part there. And we'll rest, because we haven't slept in a few days. And then we'll head back out to our crab pots, which are over this way. Go back, sell all our treasure. Hopefully be able to get our... Where are our things there? Wait. Hopefully be able to get our black paint job. Abyssal black paint job. And then we'll have a look at the end of this game. Aww. Come on. Give me some evil shit. Not good, friends. It's not fucking good. Damn it. All right. Well, never mind. We'll go back. I can't remember what I need for the. I only need one specific style of like cursed crab. Hello. Oh, you're a turtle. Hello, turtle. One specific style of cursed crab, and then that's me done. This way. Go have a look while we're speaking to the treasure dude. Right, trader. Explain to the trader that you found a use for the fused tablet at the ancient lighthouse in Devil's Spine.
It opened a door in that ruined lighthouse. Yes, that makes sense. Well, I hope you found something interesting.
I did. I found all of that shit. Which is great, but not what I wanted. Paint the boat. The roof. Black Abyss, isn't it? Yeah, I need like a cursed one of those. The umbral puppet crab. Which is a spider crab, and it's not what I want. Ah! That's what I want. I wanted to paint it fucking black. My gothic soul. Like my gothic soul. I want to get rid of my bunting as well. Don't need the fucking bunting. How tedious and annoying. What I do want to do, actually, while we're here. Just sell all the shit in our... And you know what? Let's just put loads of the crab things out. Don't have any need for the others. Oh, I could have sold that as well, but never mind. Never mind. Doesn't really matter. What is this? What I do want to do as well is take the time to actually read all of the notes. We've got a whole load of like notes that were like messages from my former wife. My dead wife. And then we'll finish up. And we'll see where we get. Pretty sure they're over here somewhere, my little crab. Doodads. Where are they? Over here? Yes, the other side. This way. Then if I do this, pain in the ass, pain in the ass. Pain in the ass. But theoretically, if I don't have the fucking chum. Damn it! I didn't bring the chum with me. I thought I had chum. I don't have any chum. I am out of chum. How damnably frustrating. But it's alright, I can get the chum from here, sleep, go back, and I should be okay. We'll rest. jump into our... Pull out the pedigree chum. Fish market. Oh, we probably should have sold these beforehand, but never mind. And then head back to Chum Island. To all of our beautiful crab pots. I just need the one cursed object. What does that do? I don't understand how the chum works. There it is! There it is, friends! No, give it to me. That's all I wanted. Right. We should now be able to get it. How's it going, Stowie? How you doing? Doom hippie, hello, you beautiful bean. Oh my god, hog money maker, hello. Embrace the crab. I definitely am embracing this crab. This crab is so unbelievably important to me, it's unreal. Give me the crab goodness. Because now I can make my boat all gothic. We can go goth boat. Henceforth, this boat shall be named Coffin. Yes, very much so. Very, very much so. The question is, friends, do we... Do we go for the collector first? Or do we go for the thingy?
That should be all we need. Let me grind them together. Right, now let me prepare my brushes. Much better. That color looks good.
Which area do you want to paint the roof? Give it to me again. Black Abyss.
Let me prepare my brushes.
Yes! Goth boat. My gothic princess paradise. What happens if we put the bunting on this now? Oh, we've got goth bunting as well. Yes, amazing. Let's do it. The morgue-mobile? Yeah, about it. No, goth boat. We're good. That's all right. I don't need anything else. Don't need nothing else. Gothy Island adventure. I am feeling it. All right, we'll do this. And then I think... The question is, friends, what do you think? Do we... Do we go with the collector, who is our occult specialist, or do we go with the lighthouse keeper, who is going to try and save us? I feel like the collector, just because we're all gothed up now, so we may as well goth it out, you know? It would match my old flight. It would indeed! It would indeed! My little goth boat. It's the only one I really wanted anyway. I'm thinking, yeah. Let me just... Oh, that's how I get the chum. All right, fair enough. Let's do haste, because haste is particularly fucking useful. How's it going, Onion Pencil? How you doing? Right, let's do it. Let's finish this, friends. Let us... Oh, we didn't finish reading the thing. Nautical Engineer. The Devil's Spine. We've 107 out of 174. But that's fine. We don't need to worry about this. to the ruined mansion.
I'm ready. We must make one final voyage. This time I'll be with you.
Oh, wait, no. What I need to do before I do that, we go in and we check the cabin. The messages. Are they in order now? 10 out of 10? Let's do it.
We are engaged to be... 6th to the 7th of March, 1927. We're engaged to be married. He sailed us out to the very center of Stellar Basin to see the lights. We talked for hours, something we have not done in such a long time. Waiting and hoping. Some time past midnight, as we're growing delirious and hysterical from the lack of sleep, the aurora shimmered into the skies above. When I turned to see his reaction, he was already down on one knee. I cannot even remember what he said, or what I said, but I know that I said yes. The ring is beautiful, with a span of jewels going right the way around. I cannot take my eyes off it. P.S. I was not sure whether to write this under yesterday's date or today's, given that it occurred at the conjunction of days. But I feel that the news is significant enough to warrant spanning multiple entries. 1st of June, 1927. Yesterday was the reading of his mother's will. Most of the remaining estate went directly to him, of course. But to my surprise, she bequeathed me her pocket watch. Curious, I am not fond of the thing, but I know that taking it will mean a lot to him. I cannot help but feel this is some veiled jab at me from beyond the grave. She was the type of thing to do such a thing. Was I late on some occasion? I cannot recall. 20th of August, 1927. Morning of the second day of our honeymoon, and the first day proper. Today, we're sailing around the islands and inlets at the back of Greater Marrow. I love the rocks here. The layers and colours are so striking. Furthermore, the fishing is relatively poor in these shallows, so I know he will keep his hands on the wheel instead of the rods. He renamed the boat last night, Julie. He did a fancy renaming ceremony and everything. I think he took that more seriously than the wedding. Supposedly, it's very important to perform it correctly, lest you want ill fortune to follow the vessel. He wanted to throw away everything with the old name on it, but I kept a keychain. Ocean Riches was a good name. I think he has prepared a surprise picnic lunch. I can see the basket half hidden, stuffed under a blanket at the front of the cabin. I love it when he tries to be romantic. August 21st, 1927. We had a slight accident yesterday around the shallows at the back of Greater Marrow. A rock seemingly appeared out of nowhere and struck the front of the boat. It did not penetrate the hull, but it jostled us around. A few items fell overboard into the water. We did not see what they were, which is of some concern, but we believe all important articles are accounted for. He has been checking over some notes from the boat renaming ceremony. He is paranoid that he performed the steps incorrectly. I have never known him to be so superstitious. September 9th, 1927.
How's it going, Sarah Greenfire?
He still refuses to take me aboard when he is working. He is convinced that I will find it dull, or that the crew will be crass or otherwise intolerable. Perhaps I am being overly needy. I know he needs time alone, but I am so desperately bored at home when he is away. He recently installed some salvaging equipment onto the boat. I think the idea of pulling up the treasure is terribly exciting. I must convince him to let me have a go. 14th of September, 1927. I have not written in a few days. I have been afflicted with some strange chill which conspires to fog my brain. I cannot seem to keep warm no matter what I do.
The ink has run from some lines here, and they are illegible.
Because most of what they hold up was junk, they eventually came up with a large wooden casket. A hush came over the crew at such a tantalizing discovery. I remember the next moments with excruciating clarity. He pried it open easily. The buckling boards cracked and groaned with relief as they splintered apart. Crimson cloth spilled out onto the deck. The crashing waves rose to fill my ears. I hear them still. He stared down into the open casket and then turned to me. In his eyes, I saw the void.
The page has been torn off here.
It feels like years since I have been warm. I do not expect him to write. I just need to know that he thinks of me from time to time.
Next few lines have been smudged out.
He must return.
More angry smudgings.
I have written him another letter. This will be the last one. My darling, I have found you at last. When you left, I was scattered to the winds. But now, I feel almost whole again. There is just one thing left to do. Throw me back.
Artifact manifest. Vessel, the SY Grand Prize. Owner, Michael Schultz. Port, Gale Cliffs. Oaken music box. Purchased from antiquarian at Little Marrow for the bargain price. Previously salvaged from an undisclosed shipwreck. As the letter J carved on the underside, otherwise in reasonable condition, has not been opened for fear of damaging the mechanism. Pending inspection by locksmith. Wooden mask, a carved wooden tribal mask. Said to bring good luck. Fertility, good health, fortune, rain, and protection from evil spirits. Traded for a pair of socks and a pocket watch chain. 12-piece china set. Bone china, 6 cups, 6 saucers. Acquired from an eastern dealer. Do not use. And a jar of earth. A jar containing earth from a meteor impact site, allegedly. Goldsmith and Son. Number 27, Little Marrow. December 22nd, 1926. Received the sum of £50, $50.00 in exchange for one silver necklace with emerald on silver mounting. Additional notes. Received a further $3 for custom engraving on the reverse mounting. Custom for return tomorrow, 23rd of December, for collection. Engraving is to be as follows. 4J, my shining star. This shipwreck is brought to you by X. Yeah, basically, yeah. Okay, this is really interesting stuff. This is really, really interesting stuff, and I'm going to get into it in a minute. But first, Asari Greenfire redeemed vanity promo, which means that I need to tell you about stuff that I do, friends. And I'm going to tell you about my merchandise. I have a merch store, !merch. It's full of really interesting and peculiar and bizarre and delightful designs across all medium of different styles of bits and pieces so that you can enjoy random shit. All of the money, like, obviously, the fourth wall will take a cut of it, and then anything from like leftover comes to me, which is absolutely fucking amazing. Thank you very much, Nibirin. Yeah, if you like peculiar stuff, especially LGBTQIA promoting styles of merchandise, then please check it out. Check it out. See if you like it. See if there's something that you like in there, and flag it for later or what have you. Just give it a look-see. Give it a look-see. We've got all of the sexualities, where it's like a whole load of puns based on different sexualities and stuff. Yeah, it's really cool. Really, really cool stuff. I like it. That's the reason why I have it, you know? That's the reason why I have it. Notes. Ragged note. Post now. Nobody knows. Nobody knows. Does he know? Desecrated temple. Forgive me. The only way he might understand. We must help him. We must stop him. Okay, so there's another note in the world. And no journal entries. What the fuck have I missed? How have I missed stuff? Is there a way to get a sensor that I can... Oh, no. Is there a way to get a sensor? That I can actually, The workshop looks as though it hasn't been used in decades. Go inside. It's locked. Damn it. All right, let's get rid of this and get rid of this. And then I think we're about as ready as we can be. The only thing we don't have is these large scraps of paper. But let's have a look. So we've got two little islands, a little chicken drumstick island with a tiny little bite out of it. Let's see if we can find that on the map. Chicken drumstick island with a tiny bite out of it. Oh, that's where the crabs are. I don't know where they're... Possibly here? Chicken drumstick island with a tiny bite out of it. One at the top and one here. We can get rid of that one because we've already done that. We can get rid of that one because we've already done that. And we can get rid of this one because we've already done that. And we can get rid of this one because we've already done that. I don't think it is that one. There's a big question mark, but that's the DLC that I don't really want to be delving too deeply into. Unless, of course, that is part of the DLC. Not sure, you know. Sensor, I know you were not saying, but my brain went there. What do you mean, Sogatani? I don't sense in nothing. we were literally spent an entire conversation yesterday talking about fuck dolls. So she kept the old boat name. Aren't sailors superstitious about the nature of working in seas? Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. That's what we were doing. We were looking at that. So, exactly. As one does. So, the whole thing that we found out so far is that my character was the old fisherman. So, the beginning of the game, you wash up with no memory of anything. No, your boat crashes on the rocks. You wash up with no memory of anything. And, we have basically found out that I am the old fisherman who married this woman. She kept a marker of the old fishing boat, which is bad luck for a fisherman. We then pulled up a crate from the deep. The deep crate, I think I found the red covered book in there. And, oh, I know where we can go while we're at it. We found the red covered book in there, and that cascaded the void into us. There was a guy down here. And then our wife basically became more and more depressed over time. And gave up on us. Whether she became depressed or whether she became part void herself, because whatever magics it was just hollowing out her soul. We will never know. And you never told me where to buy one? A life-size fuck doll of myself? Of course not! I could put far more use to $7,500 than a life-size fuck doll of myself. Evil monsters. You bastard. So yeah, she kept that, and then all of that other stuff was basically about the them finding my old boat and pulling up all the little bits from it, you know? Campsite, you stand in the center of the campsite. Oh, wait. Where's the guy? There was a guy. The guy has disappeared. Oh, cheeky. God damn it! The guy has disappeared. Never mind, I suppose. The Wine Dark Sea. There's a Wine Dark Sea over there. Over that direction. Well, that direction over there. Is where all the winey seas are. They're the volcanic ones, so they turn a slight hint of red. Do you know what I mean? A mythical Monday on superstitions of the sea and sailors. Oh, we could do that. We could definitely do that. Although I feel like there's... That would be very different depending on where you go. Let me... Get the... Ooh! The Cleft Mouth Shack. Cheeky. Oh my god. I will take this Cleft Mouth Shack. Sell these ridiculous things on. It's more stuff that we just need to find, you know. Not that we really need anything now. We've pretty much bought everything. And there's not much else we can purchase. Not with the way these all fucking work. Fuck it, let's go see if we can resurrect our delightful partner. Let's do the evil ending first. And then we'll see what the other ending's like, you know? Right, let's go see if we can find our reflection. Because it turns out... So basically, throughout the game, for those people that don't know, there was this character called the Collector, who looked like this guy. Who looked like us. I didn't know what we looked like. I had no idea what we looked like. So this character was just all strong and dignified and had this red book with the silver inlay. And the whole way through, the Collector's been getting us to collect things which were mementos of the Collector's wife, who we assumed, because we assumed that the Collector was the fisherman, or the old fisherman. And... Yeah, it was very, very, very well done where we were collecting the fisherman's wife stuff. So the pocket watch, the engagement ring, the necklace, like all of this stuff. Only to then be like, give us the fucking book. Give us the book. We want the fucking book. Smash the mirror. Like go to punch the Collector only to find that it's a fucking mirror. Let's do it. Let's fucking do it. Let's go. Warning, you are entering the final phase of the game. Your progress will not be saved from this point onwards. Do you wish to continue? Yes. One more time. Your progress will not be saved from this point onwards. Yes. I'm glad that they do that. I'm glad that they give you multiple warnings. The relics are coming with us. We should wait for the fog to thicken. With luck, these seas will remain unaware of our intentions. I'm quite excited.
Now, our destination is the open expanse to the west of Greater Marrow. It's marked on the map. We must not tarry on the open waters, not with such a significant cargo. Make haste. His shape disappears from the mirror. A chill rises in your body as you turn to leave. The Collector is with you.
Here. Alrighty. I'm quite excited, friends.
get the atmosphere going on.
This is the place. This is where she was taken from us, and where we can, at last, bring her back. Only here, and only because of what we've achieved. You open the book. Its pages are frosted with ice, and chill mist rises around your fingers. You begin to read aloud. To release a lost one frozen in time. You throw the pocket watch overboard. And tethered by chains in the deep. You throw the necklace overboard. Bind them to this world once more. You throw the ring overboard. Open the door to the starry heavens. You slot the key into the lock of the music box. And lay the weary world to rest. You throw the music box overboard, its key left unturned. Oh my fucking god. That was so well done. That was so well done. We raised her from the deep, but in the process also raised the thing. The horrible thing from the depths. You killed the world. Yeah, just a bit of killing of the world. Just a bit of killing of the world. That was fucking amazing. I love that ending. We're going to go see what the other ending is as well. Don't you worry. But I love that ending. That was really fucking cool. That was really, really well done. We woke something. Some kind of cosmic horror. Whether it be Cthulhu. It didn't look quite like Cthulhu. But that was very, very cool. We looked away for 1 second. Oh, you missed it. You missed it, I'm afraid. Oh, that was so well done. Oh my god. I fucking love that. Absolutely fucking love that. Came back right after the end. I missed it. Yeah, Zach, no!
Subscribed. Missed kind.
40 months. That's been a long pregnancy.
It certainly has been a long pregnancy. How's it going, Andreas? How you doing, you beautiful bean? I realize that we're going to watch this in a second, so we can skip the thingies in now, because we're going to do this anyway. But while I'm doing that, we're going to go see what the other ending's like, okay? How's it going, Nayasa? How you doing? Andreas, you genie devil, 40 months! I should now inscribe your name upon the mirror. Vein. By having your name upon the mirror, Vein, it means you get access to my personal Snapchat. Not a bum Snapchat, you cheeky devil. And of course, you get access to all the sexy little emotes. But the most important thing is you got to roll over every morning. Look in the mirror. Go, oh God, I look rough. Well, God damn, do I make rough look good? Ooh, sexy. Ooh, yes, meow. You know? Ooh. You misspelled pregnancy? That's all right. That is perfectly okay. Oh, thank you very much, Semba. For the people who blinked, I appreciate it. But we are going to... So we've done that ending where we raised our darling from the deep. Let us go and do the other ending. Because this game has been absolutely fucking fantastic, and I have thoroughly, thoroughly enjoyed myself. Not the fishmonger. We want to see the lighthouse keeper. What do we have to do? Nothing. Right, lighthouse keeper.
What is it?
I'm ready to show me where I need to go. Warning, you're right in seeing the final phase of the game. You will not save from this point onwards. You wish to... Yes. One more time. Yeah, that's fine.
We must wait until night is thickest. Until the ocean is as it was all those years ago.
This is very cool. This is very, very cool. Thank you very much, Senbar, for clipping that. I really appreciate it. I'm doing censored, and it's really been censored time. Thanks for asking. Oh, really interesting. How intriguing.
It's time. I will point the way. Follow my light. Go and do what's right for her. Throw it back.
Follow my light. Oh. Oh, is she pointing to exactly the same place as where she died? Yeah, she is, yeah. Cool that that is the way it works. Is that it's the same place regardless, you know? I throw it back for Valent. Oh, Stewie, you cheeky devil. What do you like, eh? What do you like? This is the place. Throw it back. The book struggles in your grasp, its weight somehow shifting from side to side, silver ribbons flailing pathetically against your fingers. Throw it back. You hold it high above your head. A low groan rumbles from the book, echoed by another from the depths. Throw it back. You throw it into the foaming water. Oh, that was equally good. I wasn't expecting that. In order to save the world, you sacrifice yourself. That's very cool. That's really fucking cool. You throw the Book of the Void back into the depths and as a result get eaten by cosmic horror itself. Now it's Godzilla, basically, yeah. I did, yeah. I was expecting it to, like, swim underneath me as sort of like a reclaiming the book. I was not expecting me to fucking die like that. That was very fucking cool. That was very fucking cool. I enjoyed that. That was a really, really nice. And do you know what? I love it because cosmic horror is, like, nobody wins. Did the Lighthouse Keeper sacrifice you? I suppose, yeah, that's one way to look at it. Yeah. The Lighthouse Keeper sacrificed me in order to, keep everyone safe. Yeah, quite possibly for sure. But that was very, very cool, the way that, like, in cosmic horror stories, nobody wins. It's all about doing the best for everyone else, because no matter what you do, you always die, or you go completely fucking insane, or you spend an eternity fucking in being tortured or what have you. Like, there is no, like, winning, you know? Thank you very much, Senbar, once again for clipping that so that people can check it out, you know? All of the above, yes. Yeah, that was fucking intense. That was fucking intense. Really, really enjoyed that. We're going to watch all of the credits because I feel like when I sit and play a game and I really fucking enjoy it, it's worth seeing who actually put their time and effort and skills and talents into the game, and I fucking great. Yeah, really, really fucking enjoyed it. Do you know what I mean? All of the winning is relative. Winning is relative, yeah. Basic rule of Call of Cthulhu, you either die or live long enough to be driven insane. Yeah. Is it me or is the island shaking? No, it's just me. Like, I'm reading chat and every so often I see it move and I'm just like, is there a Cthulhu entity coming to destroy the island just for the sheer shits and giggles of it? No, it might be the lighthouse light just cascading in my eye. Love your take on structure of cosmic horror. Also have to enjoy the experience this mood with you. Whiskey Pixel, thank you very much. I really appreciate that. I fucking love cosmic horror stuff because there is no winning. There is something that genuinely I love about the inevitability of cosmic horror stories. You know? Okay, there's Red Flag Robert. Yeah, right. In Call of Cthulhu, you win and you die. I mean, to be honest, yeah. In Call of Cthulhu, like, Call of Cthulhu was, like, the newer game of Call of Cthulhu was the first game I ever played on stream. Do you know what? That is something we could play on stream at some point. Play the original Dark Corners of the... Is it Dark Corners of the World? Yeah, Dark Corners of the Earth? No, so we played the newer version of Call of Cthulhu on stream, and that was the first ever game that I played. I own Dark Corners of the Earth, but I haven't played it. But that would be an interesting game to play on stream at some stage, just for... Like, it's an old-school game, do you know what I mean? It's old-school graphics and stuff. I think it'd be quite fun. Maybe because your background is moving? Maybe. Yeah, maybe. Also, the credits in the foreground. Yeah, maybe it's just like the corner of my eye every so often. It just looks like everything shudders a little bit. And I was like, fucking hell, have we got a Cthulhu coming around the corner? You know? Dark Corners of the Earth. Yeah. Watching all the credits. Yes. I think it's worth watching all the credits because at the end of the day, these people put their time and effort and talent into a game. It, like, and realistically speaking, we're just going to be talking about it. So why not watch it? What we'll do at the end, because I've still got some plenty of time left streaming, we might quickly look into the DLC and see what's on the DLC stuff. I am not going to play the DLC stuff on stream. What I'll do is I will play the DLC stuff off stream and put all the VODs onto the VODs and Vanity YouTube channel so that if people want to watch it, they can do, but we're able to crack on with another game next week, you know? I think I remember you started Call of the Sea, but didn't stream it. Did you ever finish it? I didn't Whisker Pixel because that game is so unoptimized, so unbelievably unoptimized that I can't play the game and record it at the same time. I can't play the game and stream it at the same time because my computer just cannot fucking handle it. And my computer is a relatively good computer. It's just that the game is so badly optimized that it just can't handle it. It genuinely can't handle all of the little bits and pieces. Do you know what I mean? It eats CPU while it runs. Yeah. And I've got a good CPU, you know? It just absolutely ruins it, which is a pain in the hoop because it was good. I from what I understand, people absolutely fucking love Call of the Sea. But I love a good cosmic horror. I'm a big fan of... Cosmic horror is probably my favorite genre, generally speaking. It's my favorite genre. I genuinely fucking love it. And there we have our final scene. You know? Let's continue and just see where we get with the DLC. See what actually is going on with the DLC. So, we've already done all that bit. Let's go have a look at the thingy. I wonder if... can somebody... Genuine question. Are there only two endings? Are there only two endings in this game? Our final scene. Oh my god, Stoey. Really? Really? What is this? Give me the giant fish. Or should I say daddy? What is this? You pull up to a wreck with a familiar-looking hull. It's almost identical to the ship given you by the mayor, except this one has a huge breach on one side. You're tied up alongside the old wreck. Look in the cabin. You're in the cabin. Look in the cupboards and the drawers. The cupboards have been completely and methodically emptied. All the drawers are missing. You're in the cabin. Try to find a loose floorboard. There aren't even any floorboards left. You're in the cabin. Check the overhead electrical equipment. The equipment is all still there, though surely exposure to the elements has fried the internals. You angle the overhead radio down to get a closer look. A note slips off the top. You put it in your pocket to read it later. Oh my god, this is amazing. Extra shit! Extra shit we didn't find, friends! Check out the cargo. You poke through the cargo hold. Few items remain. Not yet lost to the sea. Oh my god. A basic fishing pole. Metal scraps and a weak valve engine. 20.3. 28.1. Yeah, so none of these things we really need. So this is my old boat? That's very cool. That is very, very cool. Map. My old boat. Just the two endings according to Google. Thank you very much for checking out. I really appreciate it. Let's go see what's down the far reaches. So we are now going all the way down here. Which means we're off this way. The good ending can only be seen if you find the secret NPC in-game. Oh, really? That's pretty cool. I found that NPC completely by accident as well. Okay, so this is where the DLC starts. Whoop, cheeky. Ooh. A bursting anglerfish. That is terrifying. Okay, so the DLC is the Pale Reach, and therefore naturally all about the traveling merchant. Oh my god, this is great. Does the game have any consequences for overfishing? Yes, but only if you use magic to overfish. So There is a magic that you can use that basically kills all of the fish in the surrounding area, but fills up your cargo. And if you use that too much, then it's like overfishing and like stocks get completely depraved, but also more monsters come and say hi. You know? Can you name the boat? No, but I would name it Julie. After my former wife who died at sea because I was a dickhead. You know? Yeah, no. Only one I'm aware of is a snarky achievement. Oh god, wow. That's an alien three fish? Definitely is. Definitely fucking is.
Down here to investigate the ice fields too. It seems they might have appeared out of nowhere. My best guess is they drifted up from the south. Either way, I thought I should set up a pontoon here. But when I went to stake my claim, I noticed some other equipment on the ice. Come and check it out when you've got a second. In the meantime, I've got some new rods for sale. They'll be perfect for fishing on the ice around here.
Love this. Okay, first of all, let me sell all of my shit. And I don't need to repair or anything, but what's this? Ice and oceanic. Just ice. Ice and oceanic. Abyssal, Oceania, blah, blah, blah. That's really annoying. That. I can't fit it in here. That's so frustrating. Let's take these because we can. That is very frustrating. Well, we won't worry about it for the moment. Do you know what I mean? It's a sad story. The whole thing is very much a sad story, definitely. But that's why I like it. That's why I fucking like it. You know? Can we get a new rod that does ice as well? No, it's just their ice. Okay, cool. Fair enough. We've done all the pots. Coastal, oceanic, coastal, volcanic. Fuck it, we'll update those while we can, I suppose. So, really speaking, let's uninstall that and stash it there, and then we'll get this one. Update that. Abyssal, Haddle. That one does Abyssal and Haddle as well. And that's just ice. Coastal and shallow. Do we have oceanic, mangrove, shallow, abyssal, and haddle? So if I uninstall this, what's this one? Oceanic, mangrove, and shallow. Abyssal, haddle, ice, and oceanic. So I need a coastal and shallow. God, that's such a pain in the hoop that I can't fucking jiggery-pokery this properly. Because that does everything else. But I don't need mangrove. I don't need... So, realistically speaking, what do I need? Coastal and shallow, realistically. That's shallow. That's shallow. That's ice. Do I need any of that? If this is all just ice, then I don't really need to worry about it, right? How's it going, Faust? How you doing? How's it going? This game seems to be more complex than it appears in first glimpse. It can be, but yeah, like the way it eases you into it is actually quite simple. It's not that much of a problem, do you know what I mean? The traveling merchant has crossed over to the nearby iceberg and is inspecting some old pieces of metal. You approach.
It's so weird. This stuff seems like old, like really old.
She kicks a large sheet of metal, half embedded in the ice. A thin layer of snow dislodges, revealing lines of rivet holes.
And come in here, look.
You follow her into a small makeshift shelter, ruined by years of harsh weather. Inside are some schematics nailed to a table, still barely legible.
See how they angled these sheets? And the lining of the metal around the bow? Bow, even? Whoever was here, I think they were constructing an icebreaker.
Could you make another one use of these, one of these plans?
Probably, but let me see.
She trudges outside again and paces outside the length of the metal scraps on the ice.
We've got most of the basic materials here already, but of course, we're missing the most crucial pieces. An icebreaker needs specially tempered angled metals, as well as components designed to minimize the impact to your hull. I can't see any of those here, but whoever left all of this stuff, maybe there's left other pieces elsewhere. Or maybe you'll be able to find their old ship and salvage the icebreaker they already built. That would be convenient. Anyway, to build a new icebreaker, I need these parts.
Oh my god, right, okay. Icebreaker bracing. Okay, cool. Cool, 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 cool. I like a little bit of complexity. Yeah, I would say that the way that it lures you into the complexity is actually quite good. Like, there's no part of this that I feel like I can't do. Do you know what I mean? Like, there's no part of it that I'm like, oh shit, this is like really fucking me up. Everything works. And works really nicely and feels like easy to understand with the pacing of the game. Yeah. All right, let's rest up here and then start afresh in the ice and see where we get. Okay, so that'll be for the icebreaker. So this is the DLC. Oh, you are fucking pissing me off. This is for the DLC. What do we get? Ooh. Oh, we got an astral ice fish as well. That works for me. That's all I really want, is just investigating more stuff. I don't really need money at this stage, so not really a problem. Toothfish. Species added to data encyclopedia. That works for me. Just trying to get more experience. How's it going, Lamp? Hello, you beautiful bean. I don't really need any of those. What do we find? What's this? Photographer?
Fisherman, I didn't expect to see you this far south. Well, this is a fortunate turn of events. There's a narwhal somewhere in this ice field. I couldn't get any further in, so I've been trying to take a picture from here with no luck. I tried placing some scraps of fish on that ice sheet over there to entice it, but I didn't have long enough to hold its attention for long. I only caught a glimpse. I don't suppose you have any fish prepared that you're prepared to donate to the pursuit of wildlife photography. Fill the space entirely with any fish that you like. You can... I can't imagine a narwhal being too picky.
Sure, you can take these. And these.
That's perfect. Now cut your engines. We need to wait in complete silence.
Waiting in silence.
I think I hear something under the ice.
That is quite the narwhal.
What on earth was that thing? I'm not sticking around to find out.
Don't worry. I will. Oh, it's interesting that it's not giving us the map for it. That's pretty cool. Oh, more creepy fish. Oh, I love this. Do you know what? Doesn't matter. There's a thing over here I want. Oh. That's how we do it. Forgot how to dredge for a second there. Oh, it's a bit of the fucking thing. Oh, amazing. Cool. Right. That's great. I can dredge my way around. Ooh, hello. Just need a bit of a mining laser? Definitely. Wait, wrong game. There's an ice fish, an ice fish, another ice fish, and an ice fish! All of the ice fishes! I like the ones that are, like, corrupted. The corrupted fish just make me fucking happy in this game, you know? Just getting some very exciting news and totally not boring math stuff done. I mean, I'm glad that you're not bored by your math stuff. It was indeed a lightsaber narwhal. I'm very interested. What is the math stuff?
A cold wind whistles through the doorway of the only cabin still standing. Behind it, a frozen over dig site is littered with tools and debris.
Let's check out the frozen cabin first.
You enter the small cabin.
The door, long since fallen from its hinges, a rotting table sits inside. A crudely drawn map of the area has been charted onto a scrap of paper. You attach it to your own map. A large book still sits on the table. It is well worn from the passage of time, but you can still read the words "Captain's Log" etched onto the cover. You open the book. Its frozen spine cracks for the first time in decades. Which entry do you want to read? 30th of May, 1847.
Arrived at the floating sea ice amidst a particularly thick fog. A few channels could be seen leading into the ice, though sizable chunks floating are in our way, posing a hazard. I have ordered us to moor against the outer ice wall, while these engineers make adjustments to better prepare the vessel. The vessel was pursued by a particularly aggressive narwhal. Some men placed fish on the ice nearby in an effort to distract it. It appears to work, though only for a time. It resurfaced and needed satiating repeatedly. If we can't find a more permanent solution to the beast, we have to make sure we can keep enough fish on our hands to placate it. As I lay falling asleep, the most almighty voice spoke unto me. It resounded from the thick ice below, at once both powerful and ethereal. There was no mistaking this as a trick of the wind, nor a jest by the crew. It did not pause for response or acknowledgement, but whispered a cryptic prophecy. At first, I could not make sense of it. Three listeners shall hear the heart, and that I should indulge in these listeners. It spoke of the boundless wealth from the stars, and of eyes opening unto the world. The rest of my sleep was feverish, as my mind was plagued with the sound of the voice. It spun in my head, echoing ever louder. In the morning, the boatswain and the navigator came to me separately, claiming to have heard a sound like a heartbeat, as the men were digging yesterday. They indicated a desire to explore the eastern and western reaches of the ice field. I shall indulge them.
Well, shit. Shark with a friggin' lightsaber. I think it's a narwhal, some kind of narwhal. It's like indexing numbers and calculating stuff like prices. Oh my lordy lamp. That does sound exhausting. You don't get to do the exciting type of math when you're in accounting, but it's still fun to figure out how to do it correctly. That is fair. That is fair. Oh my lordy. An ice pierces through the... light pierces through the ice, intensifying and concentrating to a glow in the center. A dark form takes a shape against the light. Place an ear to the ice. A distorted voice echoes from within.
Don't disturb the ice.
Who are you?
Captain, the expedition. Chart the ice field. Appeared suddenly through the eyes.
What happened here?
It whispered, promised stones from the stars. It knew three would hear the heartbeat, the heart beneath the eyes.
The voice grows louder.
It commanded three listeners, three sacrifices for three eyes. I obeyed, but a fourth now sees, forever futile.
The shadow is silent for a time.
Slumbering still, should leave. It sees you before it whispers.
Break the ice.
Do not risk breaking. It senses through the ice. through the shadows. No hope.
Okay, so I need to find some kind of ice pick. We'll rest here so we don't go completely insane. However, friends, before we go any further, I want need to go visit the urination station once again, because I have indulged myself a little too much in the old tea. However, I want another one. So, friends, get up, have a stretch, stretch your eyes, look at some in the distance, and look back again. Grab some kind of beverage, hot, cold, or if the time is permitting, flamboyant as fuck. Don't forget to take your meds, if you haven't done already. Take them now. And if you're wearing a binder, have a couple of deep breaths. Stretch those lungs out. Stretch those rib cages out. And I'll be back in about 3 minutes. I'll run 3 minutes of adverts to get them out of the way so that they're all done and dusted. Oh, Andreas, I realized that you did a whimsical fact as well. I'll give you that as soon as we get back. All right? All right? So get up. Do your thing. I'll be back momentarily, you beautiful beans. All right? All of the joyously creepiness. All of the joyously creepiness. Let me give Andreas their whimsical fact about six. Let's have a quick look. See. What is this? All right. Here we go. Andreas, are you there? Mostly live in the state of confusion, personally. That is fair. Mild agitation because anxiety do be like that. That is also fair. But you're very, very welcome. Doom hippie, you lurk away, you beautiful being. I appreciate you. Andreas! Here's a whimsical fact for you. Whimsical fact about sex. Did you know, in accordance with the American Academy of Sleep Medicine, they have found that sleep-deprived men are more likely to believe that people want to have sex with them than well-rested men. You are much more likely to believe that people want to fuck you if you are sleep-deprived. There you go. So says American Academy of Sleep Medicine. Well. That was a new one on me. I have to say. Anyway, friends, let's jump back into the game. Because I'm very much enjoying this at the moment. All right, let's leave up. Oh, no, I rested till the following dawn. Oh, right. Okay, never mind. Well, sorry. It's just another day. We're taking it very slowly. Yeah. Spent an extra day here because we're really chilly and we just wanted to warm up a little bit. Okay, so do I have a... Oh, I do. This is very cool. I like the way that it's not just like an addition of the map. It's like actually like sellotaped on. I think that's very, very cool. I like the way they've done that. Oh, I want to get in there. But I can't until I get the ship breaker. Oh, leaving fish here would probably attract a monster. They get gone real quick. And these are all rotting. I don't know whether they'll turn into rot that quickly. I don't really need any, like, money, so this is just me trying to get... I knew it. Fucking... Ah, no. Let's
get rid of that. We need to repair some shit as well. Okay, so I reckon that's probably going to be enough to get the narwhal. Yeah, we can definitely do this. Cool. No fish will fit on the pile. Oh, that narwhal's got claws. It's like part bear, part narwhal. That should keep it satiated at least for a little while. And we can get round here. If we just keep doing this, then we've... I suppose we don't really need to. Just if we ever get to a point where we do need to. That looks like a giant claw. That does look like a giant claw. Okay. Alrighty. Gonna go leave the office. No worries, you take it easy, Andreas. Thanks very much for stopping by. You dock against the small platform of ice formed around this gigantic clawed hand. You are not the first to find this place. Remnants of a long abandoned camp litter the ice. The frozen equipment. You rummage through a small pile of equipment in the snow. Most items are stuck fast in the ice, but it seems a small backpack. Inside a small backpack, you find an old journal, which entries you want to read. Oh, let's do this again. 2nd of June, 1847. Captain ordered us to make camp on the ice in the center of the lagoon. After we saw those lights in the ice, everyone's got treasure on their minds. Treasure hunting isn't exactly what the expedition was commissioned for, but given the captain gets the lion's share of whatever we find, it doesn't surprise me that he's willing to bend the rules a bit. We started digging after the camp's done. Spent the day digging down in the ice. Shovels and ice picks. Can't remember the last time I was this tired. We were only allowed 2 short breaks all day, down in the pit. I rested with my back against the ice. I started hearing something. It was different to the sounds of the picks. It was short and sharp. This was low, a rumble from the deep down. On my first break, it was occasional, only a few each minute. By my second break, it had quickened like a heartbeat. The captain overheard me telling some of the others about the sounds I had heard in the pit. Before I knew it, I was in front of his desk, sure I was about to have my pay docked. To my great surprise, he seemed to know something of it already. He was keen on hearing it described over and over. He wants me to help locate the source of it. When he's pressed me on it further, I said that it did seem to have been coming from the east. Tomorrow we're setting off to see if we can find it. Perhaps I should get a bonus after this is done. Okay. An unnatural spire of ice, scrapes of snow towards it, placed near to the ice. An anguished voice cries from deep within the ice.
Help me, frozen so many years, free me. Please, break the ice.
Who are you?
I am the boatswain, the expedition, the terror. Please break the ice.
What happened?
The figure contorts through painful shapes. We saw lights dancing in the ice, dug deep, didn't know. I heard it, the heart beating under the ice, the cracking, waking noises in the east. It went. The captain brought him here to find the hand in the night. Shadows of claws.
The darkness shrinks.
I turned away. Just a moment. The pain, the claws, my back. So cold, so dark, under the ice. Please break the ice.
I can't break the ice because I don't have...
the things that are needed to break the ice. I don't know whether I need one each of those things. Ooh. We'll take treasures. We'll take the treasures. The opal ring. Ooh, new fish. A lizard fish. What I could probably do with is leaving. I can't leave this way. That's annoying. It's very cool that you can still see the lighthouse from here. All right, well, let's sleep here because we can't fucking see where we're going. Rest up. And then we'll get back. Oh, wrong one. So on our little map, we've got the eastern terminus, central camp. So if we go up and around, something we should probably do is go back to our... If we go back to the lady, the traveling merchant, she might be able to get us... Yeah. She might be able to get us the stuff that we need. Can't go this way because I don't have... That's new. Oh, no, it's not. I've definitely got that. But I've broken that, so I can't do it. So I need to go back to the lady anyway. So let's go back, get stuff repaired, and drop off all the bits we need for the little slow snow wedge we've got. However, if this is a way that we can put some fish in here... These are all rotting anyway, so that actually works perfectly for us. Because I can't do them anyway. Go on, Nigel. Violence this stuff. We're good. Because if we can... get what we need... But you know what? I'm not gonna keep doing this. I'm not gonna keep. Ooh! Hello. We'll keep doing this. Oh my god, come on, Valen. Getting too excited. We got there. In the end. Jesus Christ and the wheel of donkey. That's better. I've got a feeling that might be the only thing we really need. Hello, sharks. Oh, a goblin shark? That's very, very cool. Love a good goblin shark. Can we get some evil ones of these? We can. Even more. The thawed ice fish. Oh, Jesus. You named him Nigel? I mean, yeah. Oh, wow. They are really getting all of the evil ones. Nautical engineering complete. Huzzah! We love a good nautical engineering. And I've got two of the evil ones. I don't need anything else. I can't get through there yet, but we can check out this little area here and see what's going on. Are the other creatures might end the world? I think this one could rip it in two. I mean, to be honest here, another makeshift camp constructed in the shadows of the frozen clawed hand. Someone was seeking these out. Frozen equipment. Few pieces still remain, however. Whoever made camp here was poorly prepared. Inside a small bag, find a leather-bound journal. We love a good leather-bound journal.
The men spent the whole day digging. They passed up chunks of ice, some as brilliant as crystal, others of a deepest blue, more beautiful than sapphires. But none held the glow we had seen in the night. However, I did note that a disturbance in the ice to the west began as a periodic distant rumble. As the men dug deeper, the pulsing quickened, strengthening until I could see the ice shifting on the surface. I shall have to inform the captain. It may well be that the narwhal creature we saw earlier, though this did seem much larger. As I write this, I can feel my eyes closing. We'll have to wait until the morning. This morning, the captain appeared out of the fog, rowing alone. Apparently, the boatswain remains at camp in the east, waiting for the nightfall. They were unsuccessful in their search. It does make sense that the lights would be more visible at night. Tomorrow, we're journeying together to the west, towards the shifting ice I reported. We are alone on a small island of ice. After hours of rowing through narrow channels, it rose through the fog, a gargantuan, monstrous claw reaching from the deep. Whatever creature it once belonged to must be long dead, as the claw is frozen solid. I wanted to turn back immediately, but the captain insisted we investigate. He is on edge, his head turning this way and that, listening for the slightest sound. He is convinced something will happen after dark. As the last light from the cold sun fades, I have the sense that it will be a long night.
Oh, the other creature. Yeah, you're playing the DLC. How exciting. Haven't actually played this part of the game yet. Well, if you don't want spoilers, now's gone. To be honest with you, I thought the DLC was going to be a bit longer than it seems to be. I was going to play it offline and just upload it on to the VODs channel. But if this is as short... Oh my god. Hold on a minute. Chunk is burning things. Or more specifically, something is burning and Chunk happens to be in the kitchen. Yeah, if this game is as short as it looks to be, then I might just finish it off next week. I might just do that. We'll see. We'll see what it gets. I might even finish it in like the time that I've got, you know?
An unnatural spire of ice stands above the scraps of snowed over equipment. A large shape twists within. A voice calls out, distant and distorted. Trapped! Forever! This prison! Get me out! Break it! Somehow! Free me! The navigator! Find safe passage! Chart the ice! It came from beyond! Break it! Somehow! Free me!
What happened?
The digging! The cracked ice! Like a web awoke the ice heart! I told him, whispers in the west, took the boatswain east, returned alone.
The dark figure shudders, sending vibrations through the ice.
The next day, rode here. The captain saw the claws, gripped my soul. He insisted, made camp, shadows of the beast. Waiting for the stars in the night, I saw his shape
suddenly swallowed by the cold. In the dark, he left me.
And we will break the ice as soon as we are able to do so, friendo. Fire!
Fire burns much brighter when oxygen is the supplier. Fire kills my desire to not be cold as I expire.
Right, how the fuck do I get out of here? Over here. That's the main camp.
Up. Oh, look at that. Look at that skillful navigating of the ice there.
Look over in chat. Get distracted naturally. Now, I think I should be able to get the... This should be the last thing I need for the ice plow, as it were. So I should be able to get through all of this ice as I come back. As I return. I tell you what, for somewhere that is meant to be so fucking unbelievably cold that ice is on the surface, my fish don't half get rot very quickly. Build a new icebreaker.
That's everything. Just let me warm my hands up a little, then I'll get started.
Installing the icebreaker.
All right, I think that should do it. The front of your ship can now break through chunks of ice. Go ahead and test it out. I'll be watching from here.
Look at my sexy tug-tug boat. Can I upgrade it anymore? No, of course not, because it's...
I forgot to mention, just let me know... If you want to temporarily remove the icebreaker, I can swap it out at any of my pontoons.
No, just leave it on. Fuck it. How's it going, Shades? How you doing? It's a train boat. It's a train boat. Oh, tell you what I will do. Just quickly repair up, because I haven't repaired yet. And stick that in there. Hold on, what was... There was another exclamation mark of the icy worksite. What's this?
I've been looking into the schematics and found before. There are plans for another device here too. They're for an ice shaper. It's different to your ice breaker, by the way. It's for cutting chunks of ice. If you find the missing device, I'll be able to use the machine to harvest ice blocks for refrigeration. The blocks of ice can be packed into your cargo to slow fish spoiling. Pretty handy, right? This is what's missing.
Okay. So this is just a... Theoretically, can I now... Oh, yes, look at this. Oh, however, I got too excited and just crashed to the side of my boat into stuff. But now... We can smash all of the things. I don't think I actually want any of these things, but that's fine. Oh, no, I will take that. Hello. Yeah, I don't want that. Because I literally have no need for it. It's a train boat. And this is one of the things we need to break the dudes out. So we will take it. Right, we're not going to break out the captain first. We're going to break out the captain last. Because I don't trust him. I... Hello. I heard a grumbling. I heard a grumbling. Oh, for God's sake. I don't even know where I am now. Oh, right. We haven't been down here yet. Was that other one just, like, a little baby one? I think the other one was like a baby one. It was like a little baby one. And this is the big one. This is Mama Jama. Can we get down here? Anything down here? There is something down here. Fucking knew it. Hello, what are you? A sleeper shark. And that gets me back out. That's great, but first... Basically just stocking up to see if there's any more stuff that we need to gather. But first, how you doing, Shades? How's it going? It's about time for a boat freezer, right? Tell me about it. Go to the ice shard. A spire of glassy ice stands in the shadow of the cliffs across the water. A monstrous visage peers from an icy tomb placed near to the ice. A sound of anger lashes from within.
Murder! Betray your men! Left us here, your sleepless god!
The voice abates.
Wait! Your shadow! It speaks! Another shape, please save us all! Find the axe! Undo this, the betrayer!
Who are you?
First officer! Safety of the crew! Failed them! Should have. Cursed place.
Oh, those eyes are still moving in the ice. Oh, God.
Find the axe. Undo this. The betrayer.
What happened?
The men saw the lights. Southern cliffs at night. Captain and I would look into. We rode alone. He was restless, sleepless. We passed walls of ice, finally arrived. The great horn into view. The words drift
in, some carried on the wind.
Pulled ashore, quickly. The size of it, the light. Somehow he knew. Eyes were wild. He was whispering, answering. He said, it chose him alone, averted my eyes, could not help, looked upon. We fought, cold hands, an iron grip, breathless. Find the axe, undo this, the betrayer!
What is that thing in the ice?
The shape in the ice
shrinks into itself. Look at the eyes moving! Look at the eyes! So it's satisfying crunch when the ice breaks, right?
I know not. The eyes open, watching. Shadow of shadow. Through the ice, yet more. Closed still. It cannot. Arise. Break the ice. Cull the heart. Find the axe. Undo this.
Let's break the ice.
Must not fully awaken. The eyes, close them. Strike the heart.
Not that one. Let's do this one. You strike hard against the center of the shard, where the shadowy shape appears darkest. A deep crack chases upwards, cleaving away fragments that fall and shatter. Oh, cool, 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 cool. The structure peels open, split to its core. A glistening stone lies cradled by broken shapes. Wispy threads of starlight trail from it. You take the stone and leave. Oh. No, can we... The site of the final escape. The greater eye closes shut. Okay, well, let's rest until dawn. Go for the eyes, Boo! Go for the eyes! Okay, so I... can get out. We'll do the captain last. Let's get it. Oh, I do like the fact that it's not causing me fucking hell. Despite the, all of the anguish, it's not causing me too much issue. Oh, there's a thing over there. What does that do? Looks like someone built a feeding station for a monstrous whale. Let's go and... Is there one with the little fish? Yeah, perfect. That's what I wanted. I don't know what this does. Did you eat all that fucking fish? You bastard. All right, okay. So you can't leave. That's a new one. Because in the previous, in the other bit of the game, you can leave stuff all over the place and it's fine. Right, where am I going? I need to go to the Western Bearing first. Let's go to the Navigator first. Doesn't matter if these things rot because we can just refish and that's not too much of a problem. How's it going, Astro? Welcome back. Oh, let's go this way. Oh, cheeky. It's just a little too long. Been watching the new Deadpool Wolverine trailer too much. I've spotted one of the background in jokes that reassures me about the film. That's good. You put the food in his bowl and you're upset that it ate it. Yeah, kind of. The way that the rest of it works. Oh, ooh, hello. There's stuff on the outside as well. Hello. What's this? What was that? Shit. We don't need that. What is this? Oh, crap, 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 crap. Fucking ice crab. Bloody ice crab. Right, let's go and cleanse the soul of this dude. This claw. Ice shard. Break the ice. You strike hard against the center of the shard, where the shadow shape appears darkest. A deep crack chases upwards, cleaving the fragment in two. Two down, two to go. The structure peels open, split to its core, glistened as a stony thing. Stony bits and bobs. Take the stone and leave. Cool. Let's rest up till the morning and get on to the next bit. Very quickly. What are we at? Rotting. Okay. Anything else in this area? No. Okay. We'll head back, we'll put the food back in its bowl, and we should be able to... We'll just stock up a little bit on the food. Not that this really matters. Oh yeah, this brings me back inside. Okay, that's cool. let's see what happens when we do actively feed it properly. Goblin shark that should be rotting. Oh, they're just rot now. Which is not gonna work. I need more shit. More things. Damn it. They just run out so quickly. You. You're good. See what happens when we feed the puppy. The ice puppy. It's like part polar bear, part seal, part narwhal thing. Let's go and rescue the other dude. He's down here somewhere. Thank you, Nibirin, for the 200 little bits saying egg. All of the egg. Amazing. If I go in here. Oh my god! What does this do? I think this is the last one as well I need. I'm getting well and truly battered though. Oh, this is coastal? I can't even access that. What is this though? A translucent spire of ice stretches into the darkness. Pulsing glow rises on four sockets. Oh, hello. Okay. Okay, very cool. Very, very cool. So maybe this entire thing is just so that you can... The DLC is so that you can get the refrigerator unit inside. I think that's probably what it's about, isn't it? Like, actually, you can get the refrigerator unit inside your... inside the thing. There's nothing else to grab, is there? Fish market. Let's sell everything we've got. And we'll discard that. We'll do a quick research on the nets, because why the fuck not? First, should they bring down any more DLC for this game, then we can really have a play with it in Wavia's cabin. Pursuits. Explore under the ice. Find the ice shaper. Oh, this is very cool. Messages, notes. Deep sky, deep. Cask seal, broken, fog core, five rise, he knows. And the journals. These are, oh, of course, all of the journals are the other stuff. Okay. Sleep. Wake up. Shipyard.
repair. Save.
Okay, let's go. Go harvest the other guy, and then we'll do the captain last so that we're in the center and we can go wherever we need to go. Did we go down there? We did. That's the way out, isn't it? Yeah, that's where we found our last little bit. And dude. Okay. Let's break the ice of the shipswain. Ice shard. Break the ice.
You strike hard against the center of the shard where the shadowy shape appears darkest. The deep crack chases upwards, cleaving away the fragments of fall and shatter.
You take the stone and leave.
I do indeed take the stone and leave.
Oh. So no idea why I need to feed the little pup, but I don't think it really matters.
Wait.
It's not like he comes to get me. Ice shard.
Boatswain. Gone, fearful boy. The skies, we remain. The consequences inherited. Do not risk breaking its senses.
You strike hard against the center of the shard, where the shadowy shape appears darkest. The deep crack chases upwards, cleaving the fragment as it falls in twain.
In twain!
The structure peels open, split to its core. A glistening stone lies in wait. You take the stone and leave. I've read all the entries. Well, let's go and find out what the fuck that the giant thing dropped. So, when it was alive, when it was alive, all you could do was... all it could do was be frozen. And then you killed it, and it became unfrozen. What a shitty existence. How's it going, Crow Dad? Long time no see. How you doing? How's it going? Oh, I got too carried away. The Aurus Anchor. All right. A fragment of a golden splintered horn. Discordant buzzing fills the surrounding air, yearns for the deep. Cast this overboard to create a reusable two-way portal to Blackstone Isle. No, I'm good. I'm just going to keep it as a relic. Look pretty fantastic in a suit. Thank you very much. I certainly appreciate a good suit. Now, we need to go up round here. I don't know what the crabs are for. Does anyone know? Like, there's giant crabs throughout this game. Does anyone know what they're actually for? Genuine question. I can do the genuine question thing. Ooh, hello. Are you fucking... Do you know what might help is if I actually turn my lights on? Everything's fucking... That's the only thing I do find particularly annoying about this game. Is the fact that the slightest bump, no matter how slow you're going, the slightest bump, and that's it. Yeah, you're damaged. Do you know what I mean? Loved Dredge. Well, we've just completed the main game, and this is like the DLC. And I was gonna do the DLC offline and just upload it to the VODs channel, but actually it turns out that it's not that long, so you know. Pursuit resolved. The glowing in light intensifies, feeding into the four stones. A web of light grows between them, connecting, rejoining, uniting. The radiant trawl, ice shallow. Okay. That just goes straight to my storage, right? Let's have a radiant trawl. There's some stuff that we need for the quarter stargazer. You approach the hooded figure. Oh my god, not these guys again. They seem to be frozen in the spot. Pale robes frosted over, heavy with time.
Fisherman, the eyes.
You hear their jaws snap shut against from the cold.
The eyes takes form.
The hooded figure draws a scroll from the robe, unfurls it. Oh my god, you need a fractaline ice fish? Oh my god, okay, sure. So, let's just put you a fucking little tick dude by you. If I remember correctly, I believe I have to turn them in for quests. The big crabs? No, I mean, I'm talking about, like, the giant ones. Hello. The ones that are a colossal squid? Fucking hell. Catch the colossal squid was a quest, apparently. Just going around the outside now. So, you know the giant ones that have got, like, ships and stuff on their back? Those ones. Them's the ones I'm talking about. I don't have coastal. Bastards. Bastards. A craterous seer. Keep going around the outside until we find the shit we need. Haven't played the DLC, so I'm not sure. Thank you for saying you're my ignorance. That's perfectly fine. It's not really ignorance. It's just you don't know. That's cool, you know. The stone hums quietly, sending ripples through the air. Can we place a hand on the stone? Nothing. It's got to be a specific time. These stones have to be, like, specifically timed. Like this guy here. So, over here. And I don't have the ice thing because I disabled it. So, like this guy. Yeah. Aggro. Aggro, dude. Gonna check out the aggro dude. Well, that seems to be it, realistically speaking, of all of the... Apart from the... Unless this is the thing. It's groaning at me. Got metal scraps, I don't need it, but... More metal scraps. This is the thing. I don't really need any of that shit. Is that it then? Is that the whole of the... Oh, hello. Here's a golden surprise. All right, we got the ice shaper, which will help us refrigerate stuff. We'll go around it with our sexy trawler net, then we'll get rid of the trawler net. Ice works tight. This is what is missing. Good. I got it.
You really found it. How on earth do you actually locate that stuff down there in the deep? Anyway, let me slot this blade in here and yeah, that seems right. I think it's ready to start cutting. Blocks of ice coming right up. Huh. That works pretty well. Here, these are on the house.
So small ice blocks extend the shelf life of... Of fish. Okay.
From now on, I'll be able to stock these icebox at my pontoons. Thanks, partner.
Okay. So I thought I was going to be able to carry a fridge around with me, but apparently not. Apparently not. But yeah, I have to say, I do like the DLC. It's a cheeky little one, but it seems to be done. Let's just fish market. Let's sell these. I kind of want to keep that because I feel like that's going to be one of the ones that I end up using. Oh, wait. Does that get rid of the one that I've just literally fucking got? You bastard. It has as well, hasn't it? Yeah, literally by uninstalling it, it got rid of it. You fuck nugget. But that's fine, because what I can do is I can repair this. Put that over here. Thank you. I can uninstall this. And install this. And then I need a coastal one. Shallow, coastal, and shallow. One of these. So then I've got my ice and oceanic and coastal and shallow, which is all the fish that I need in this area. But overall, it's a pretty good game. It's fun. It's like we've done most of the stuff now. Fractaline ice fish, that is exactly what I needed. So we will go back out. Oh, for fuck's sake. The fucking drift on this game. The drift! And the fact that you can have like the tiniest little bump and you just suddenly break everything. That's so infuriating. What is this? Oh yeah, the lizard fish. Fuck it, that loom. They don't do anything. Oh, for fuck's sake. Oh, it's so infuriating. But it's fine. We're almost done anyway. You can't keep up with me, insanity. My ship engines are far too powerful. You wanted a fractal fish? There it is.
The hooded figure places the fish on the ice at their feet, kicking loose snow over to cover it. The stars leave the sky.
Another scroll. Type of crab? I fucking hate. Annoyingly, all of my crab fishing pots are elsewhere. Should have fucking known that they were going to be asking for crabs and stuff. Go directly over here. Ooh, a pale grasper. I have very much enjoyed this game, I have to say. So we go to the fish market. We can sell that. We don't need to worry about those things. And then net, we can sell this. These. I don't want to take it to... I don't want to sell it just yet. Because I've got a feeling I'm going to need it. Because they're after all of the deep shit, you know? That'll do. That constant worry that it's gonna just... Do you know what? Fuck it, I'll sell it. If they ask for one of them, I'm just gonna have to find another one.
Oh.
Complaining about drift when you're a seaman with a bad aim. I mean, look, sometimes, Althea Luna, sometimes, it's the speed of the boat has improved massively. But I think that might be it. I think that might be me done with the Pale Reach, which I find it was a fun little DLC, you know? It was me genuinely thinking that there was going to be far more to it, but if I go into the pursuits, the only thing I've got left is the figures in white, which is pretty awesome. Like, it was a fun little dude, you know? Have we got there's sea stars, but none of them are aberrant. King Crab. I need a fucked up one. Give me a fucked up one. Give me a fucked up one and I'll be able to do it. And that'll be me done. But that was a fun little thing. I genuinely thought that the DLC, like, the main game itself is super fucking fun. Like, really chill. Cozy cosmic horror was how it was described to me. And I think that's a really accurate way of putting it. Let's just take these because we can. And I think that, like, yeah, I think cozy cosmic horror is a fucking great way of putting it. I really enjoyed the main game. I thought the storyline of the main game was really fucking cool. I think the way that it builds you up, there's certain twists that happen in the main game that I genuinely wasn't fucking expecting by any stretch of the imagination. Like the whole collector story arc. No worries, you take it easy, Sogatani. You take it easy, beautiful bean. Yeah, the whole collector story arc was fucking awesome. The way that whole thing went down. The fact that you can find a specific story, a specific NPC to get a different ending and stuff. All the little intricacies I really enjoyed. And the fact that this is like a little extra. The DLC is a little extra that I was genuinely fucking hoping that the DLC was going to go a little bit more down the mountains of madness kind of thing. Perfect. Oh, we've got Fallen Stars. What have we got over here? We'll take what we can. They don't really matter. Fuck it. Yeah, you can take the... Oh, hello. We'll go over that way. The DLC is... I was hoping it was going to do a bit more Mountains of Madness stuff. I was hoping we were going to see more of the alien beings and more like a frozen temple that was like of really alien-esque nature. I mean, it was quite nice, the little narwhal dude. The fact there was a giant narwhal dude on top of that. Like, it was quite nice. But I wouldn't say that it was like fucking mind-blowing. Do you know what I mean? It was a nice little addition. I would definitely have wanted more if it was available. The sea stars are arranged in a circle on the ground. Moments later, a sinewy heel stomps through each of them.
Fall to the deep.
A final scroll, one stained by patches. Oh, I had one of those, you bastards! Oh, shit. I genuinely had one of those. That's so infuriating. That was the one that I was trying to save and accidentally got rid of by uninstalling my... There it is, there it is, there it is, there it is. We don't have to worry about it. Fuck it, doesn't matter. Go back, go back, go back. Yeah, I uninstalled the net and wasn't expecting it. No worries, you take it easy, Senbal. Thank you very much for stopping by. I appreciate you.
Gotta
deep.
The figure places the body of the Stargazer in the center of the crushed sea stars. They angled its cratered eye to the sky. Attention still fixed on the gruesome pile of fish in front of it, the hooded figure gestures to a book on a nearby rock for your payment. As you leave, the figure still focuses on the grim fish, adjusting its position, waiting, adjusting, over and over. Amazing. So, is that us then? 126 hours. So we missed a whole load of, like, coastal fish and bits and pieces, which is fine, like... doesn't really bother me. But yeah, overall, I've loved the game. I've genuinely loved the game. If they made another game or they made more DLC for this game, I would probably play it, because I have really been able to get fully absorbed into the game, which is really nice. And I don't think there's that much that we've not done. You know, we've covered the vast majority of stuff, so it's not really like there's a few fish that we haven't seen yet, but that's not bothering me. You know what I mean? It's not really bothering me. We've got shitloads of money left. We've done both of the endings, and yeah, I don't know, it's good. I've really enjoyed the game. I thought the DLC was going to be longer, which is why I was like, oh, I'll play it offline, but evidently it was just another little hour of game time, which was fun, you know. So yeah, I've got fucking loads of fucking money. This cast this overboard to create a reusable two-way portal to Blackstone Isle. Yeah, stash that as well. But yeah, it was fun. It was great. I've genuinely enjoyed it. And yeah, it's been fun. It's been a really interesting, fun little game. And I'm gutted it took me so long to play it, if I'm completely honest with you. I'm genuinely gutted it took me so long to play it, because I was... when it first came out, fucking loads and loads of people were playing it, and I was like, oh, like, I'll play it later. We were in the middle of something else, and this is one of the reasons why I've stopped playing like all of the voted for games, because I felt like I couldn't play this new game that really grabbed my attention, because we were in the middle of the games that we had been voting on. Do you know what I mean? That had been voted for by you. So it's not that I'm never going to do a vote again, it's that I'm just going to be careful about making sure that I can still play games that I really want to play. When Dredge first came out, I fucking loved it. I loved what it looked like. I loved that loads of people were playing it. It really appealed to me. But yeah, I don't know. It was one of those things, and I'm gutted it took me so long to get to it, because it would have been nice to have... would have been nice to have gone and checked out when it first came out, you know? Would have been nice to have done that. But anyway, friends, that's where I'm going to call it, because I've got to go out for a meeting very, 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 very shortly. So, friends, we're going to go throw some love at another delightful individual. Before we do that, could you do me a massive favor and throw out some mod loves in the channel? You can use any kind of mod loves from any kind of channel. You can use any kind of love hearts from any kind of channel. Say a massive thank you to those wonderful moderators. Mods, thank you so much for all that you do. Thanks so much for being here. Thanks so much for all you do in and out of stream. All the stuff you do for me in stream, and all the stuff you do behind the scenes for the community in the Discord and stuff, and all the stuff you do behind the scenes for me as well. You know, you're glorious and beautiful, and we appreciate you very, very much. Let me have a quick look at who we can go throw some love at. We could always go throw some love at that person, because that person is glorious and spectacular, and who haven't we raided in a long old time? Let's go raid this person. Let's go raid this glorious being. Let's go raid this wonderful specimen of humankind. Friends, if you're a subscriber, please copy and paste the first raid message. If you're not a subscriber, please copy and paste the second raid message. That's the first Botter Vein raid message for subscribers. The second Botter Vein raid message for non-subscribers. How long have you been streaming? Mm-hmm. Let's go raid Psyche. Let's go raid Psyche. Psyche is a beautiful being, a glorious individual who loves all things aliens. Loves aliens. Possibly at an inappropriate level. Possibly at an inappropriate level, all right? So let's go raid Psyche. Friends, thanks so much for being here. Thanks so much for the raids, the subs, the gift subs, all the cheeky little bees. Thanks so much for the sound alerts you threw out earlier. Thanks so much for the follows. And thanks so much for spending your time here. We'll play something completely new and different next week on the stream for Tuesday. But tomorrow we'll be back playing Poppy Playtime. And let me give Psyche a shout out as well. We'll be back playing Poppy Playtime Chapter 3 tomorrow. Friends, if you're not here in the raid, please, 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 please click on the link that I've just thrown out there so we can all throw over. Even if you can only stick around for 5-10 minutes just to go throw Psyche some love, I would very, 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 very much appreciate it. Friends, thanks so much for being with me while I've played this game. I've genuinely fucking enjoyed it. It's been really, really good. I've really enjoyed the entire endeavor of it. And yeah, we're going to have a think about what we're going to be playing next week, next Tuesday for it all, because it's not going to be the DLC because we've done that already. We've done that already, all right? I'm unfortunately going to have to raid and run as I have got a meeting that I need to go to, but you've been great and you've been glorious, and I will see you all tomorrow at 1 p.m. BST. That's 1 p.m. British time for more Poppy Playtime Chapter 3. All right, friends, until tomorrow, don't do anything I wouldn't do, because if I wouldn't do it, it'll fucking kill you. I'll see you all later. Bye bye bye.